Beer. I'm done.
All right, guys, we're recording right now. So
are we on? Are we on Ustream?
Yep, we're going.
Welcome to the YKWD podcast. I'm your host, Louis J.
What
Gomez.
The fuck? I'm guest hosted, asshole.
Whoa.
My name's Giannis Pappas. I'm filling in for Bobby fucking Kelly.
Why would that be, by the way?
Huh?
Nobody seems
he respects
to get it.
Me.
I have the radio background.
He respects me. That's why, Joe.
And I get just brushed right over. Because you know what? The one time you hosted the show, Dan, it really sucked. You were very unsure of yourself. Here's the problem, dude. You can't steer the ship and do your crazy, wacky voices at the
You're
same
right.
time. That's a lot.
Be yeah. a man in the box. You got to only be the man in the box.
Of course you can steer a ship and do crazy voices. Watch this.
Iceberg right ahead.
Perfect.
Kelly's here.
Yeah, where is Kelly? How come she's not here?
I mean, really?
She's dying.
What a good
Anything
thing.
You I should say, really she's going to hear, so just know that.
No, but I thought she was supposed to be here.
Hopefully she's dead.
She dictates every episode.
All right. You're really running
She sucks the dick
out
of dictate.
Oh,
boy. Sucks the dick. You'll warm up. We'll get you
I'm trying here, guys.
Why are we sitting so close? This
yeah,
is a bummer.
Yeah, Louis, why didn't jump to him?
Because I have to be on the camera for Ustream, because Scopo said
I said move over a little bit, not go on Joe's lap.
This is crazy. I feel like the Knights
You're getting big. If you're over there, they'll get some of you in the frame.
Yep, my right tit.
I will happily not be on camera to sit further away from you than this. Why don't you sit on the couch with Sambo?
Seriously.
I don't like the couch for these podcasts.
You are the Jewiest person I've ever met, ever.
Wow.
And I've met Yom Kippur.
I don't know. We were talking about it. I think he. You think he's a psychopath?
Sam.
Sam's
Sam
the
Morrell.
Most thoughtful, sweetest person I've ever met. Maybe the most loyal, sweetest friend I've ever had.
I'm like a Saint Bernard.
Is it an overcompensation because he feels nothing?
No, I feel
until
like,
he drinks.
I feel like Sam is he's got good guidance counselor energy. He listens and then, you know, he shows you he cares later, that he's gonna take care of you.
Sam's so thoughtful that when he asks how you're doing, he listens with his mouth open. He's like this, how are you?
Yeah, but I think
that's ADD. I'm not being Philip.
Yeah, hey, wait a minute. Can we start over? This sucks.
Yeah, this is
I'm kidding.
Also, they don't know who Sam is. I don't know why we're talking about Sam.
Sam Morrell. That's why I snuck it in. Sam Morrell.
Sam Morrell. Comedian. From the Sadie Doyle blog.
From the Sadie Ooh. Doyle blog. The Sam Morrell. The rape representative for the comedian community.
Congressman of rape.
Yeah.
All right, representing
well,
rape.
Look, I'm going up against him next election year.
No, he's got jokes. Not just saying rape.
Oh, no. I commit the act.
Yeah. Dude, Sam.
I have inspired many rape jokes.
Sam has to do something huge now, because right now, like, he's really known. Like, Brett, when we were hanging out the other night, wanted to meet Sam because of the Sam Doyle, the Sandy Doyle controversy.
So about Brett Favre.
He's like, you are the Sam Morrell?
You're
from
the guy.
Yeah, yeah. And I was like, yeah, dude, I am your eyebrow man.
You are. Sam is low, Joe is low. Scobo fix
it. Told you I was low.
I don't know how to fix it, guys.
Yeah, I don't know. My ass is weighing me down. I can't fix it.
If you were constantly sitting on something that cushy, you wouldn't want to get up either. You just want to keep relaxing. It's like he's got a fucking Tempur-Pedic always strapped to him. He's got memory foam butt.
His butt was developed by NASA.
Put a glass of red wine on his right cheek and jump on the left. The glass of wine.
Oh, God.
I really feel like in this shirt, tossing this baseball, I feel like a groundskeeper. Yeah, I used to pitch. Tigers cut me.
Joe, how do you feel about
this? That bandana?
How do you feel about us starting late today?
The bandana is being washed, by the way, because
Kelly's
has,
tears.
New kill leader. They're getting cocky. They're getting sloppy.
How sick is Kelly that we're throwing away items and?
Not lying. She told me she almost died of pneumonia. She went to the hospital.
Oh, too bad.
But she's still tweeting.
Oh, I know. God, we know.
What is with the Tinder date?
She thinks it's a thing.
Yeah, it's just.
Is she trying to do like a pissing thing?
What's
she doing? Bugging me. It's like, Kelly, don't try to do your own fucking thing.
What is it? Set it up.
Okay?
What is it? I don't know.
Comedians
what it is.
Comedians pissing is innovative and bold. I respect that.
Thank you, man. I'm a fucking groundbreaker.
What's Kelly doing?
Kelly's doing it's called Conversations on Tinder. And what she does is she trolls guys on Tinder, and when they hit her up, she just screen caps what
Please
they write
to her.
You
can't do that. That's illegal to put people's information on
well,
her.
Well, she's I don't think it's illegal. It's just shitty.
Yeah.
I think it might be borderline.
Yes, look, if she
without their consent?
If she wasn't like a fat chick who should be getting fucked off of Tinder, then I would understand. If she was like a hot chick, I'd be like, oh, ha, ha, ha. No, use Tinder for its fucking purpose, which is to get you laid.
Which, like, is, which she does, dude. You can't use it to get you laid and then be like, look at this loser trying to fuck me.
I like that Lewis is sticking up for the ethics of a thing like Tinder.
Lewis, the animal seal.
You're supposed to be there to fuck.
There's a code.
Don't leak personal information. She's the Snowden of Tinder. You shouldn't be doing this. This is classified. This is classified fuck information.
Well, that is kind of fucked up. Like, if you're on Tinder, you don't want people to fucking just put your shit out there that you're even on
so
it.
So unethical.
It's a personal conversation.
Yeah, to what? Her 14 followers? I don't really know who.
We got a couple thousand followers.
She got more followers than a lot of
please.
Why isn't Kelly fucking a comedian?
Lewis, can you
to move on up in the world?
Why is she not? Because no one will. I don't know. I think
that's the way to maneuver.
Kelly will be a very powerful manager one day.
Back here. Level 2. Oh, boy.
Does that mean? Is that too mean to say?
It was just way honest.
I just slipped up. It was just way too honest.
Just forgot. I think you thought we were in a diner for a second.
I wrote podcast.
Kelly will never be a professional.
I have more
comedian.
Followers than Kelly has.
You have more followers?
So you can take that back.
More Twitter followers? Sorry.
I broke podcast.
You. More followers than you. And you did that very dismissively. She's got a lot more followers than
because
a lot of people in this room.
Shouldn't.
Particularly us three.
Because she shouldn't, but
all right, well.
She did.
Guys!
She might have more followers than
guys,
Sam.
Guys, we're giving this.
Most definitely.
Yeah, she has more
Sam's
than
Sam's got like 11. All of his jump ship when he raped a girl.
You know what? I can't even comment on it because I feel like it's going to get me in trouble again.
Yeah, well, you should stop.
What? Sadie's just got two fingers on her bean ready for you to say something so she can start rubbing. I'm going to blog about it.
You know, he surrounds himself with people that say the word bean about vagina. Yeah. That's the first article.
Flicking the bean. No one.
No, flicking the beans, yeah. I think that's feminist.
I believe Joan Baez came up with
that.
Yeah,
I believe
the children are the future.
Yes.
That was the first line of the feminine mystique.
Now, is that wrong?
Yeah. Flick the beans. You enunciated funny.
Oh,
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez.
Joan Baez?
Yeah.
What did I say?
I saw Joan Baez live a couple times. The show started at 7 p.m. sharp, 8:15. We were out. It was amazing. It was me and Cantor. We were all banged up, drinking booze in the parking lot. There was a bunch of people in their 70s.
Is she the folk singer who's reniggin' on her gig on like a former plantation?
Did you say reniggin'?
Yeah, actually,
you
that
totally
kind of worked
did.
Out good on the former plantation.
How does that work out good? You're just saying the N-word casually, accidentally?
I said re-nigging. It's a word.
It's nagging.
It's neg.
Neg, you
re-neg.
Dum-dum.
It's oh. re-nig.
I always thought it was re-nig.
This is a common thing. People think Giannis is smart. He's not. He really is not. He really has the
it's
fucking...
It's not re-nigging?
He has
no,
the wool.
Re-nigging?
Yeah. Are you kidding me? You don't think they would have remedied that at some point in the 60s?
That's when your girlfriend fucked a black guy twice. She was reneged.
Oh, God.
Been there.
Of course, Lewis.
Welcome to the NAAC approved You Know What Dude podcast.
And you know what, dude? Sadie Boyle, suck a cock. All you dirty donkeys, suck this dick. We don't care. White power. White power.
Whoa,
white
no,
power.
No.
George, the animal steal.
That's a real fucking WCW mid 80s wrestling promo you just gave. Yeah. A bunch of shouting with mean, hateful
but
shit.
But you know what? Like, casually people say reneging. You reneged on that.
Nope.
Dan.
I'm not being corporate. I've
Dan, yeah.
Do you say coon incidents?
Yes.
Nobody's too good.
Nobody's ever said that ever.
How the fuck did you just think of that? You just went into your Rolodex of Boston racism and pulled it out?
Every time he blinks, that's actual 5 seconds of thinking. So he's just like, dude, you know what?
This is a lot of negative energy.
This is why we do it.
Oh, God, that was good. Coon incidents.
Oh, boy. Oh,
yeah,
we're
no, people
fun.
Do say reading. They do it. That's the
racist people.
Coon incidents.
No.
Coon incidents just really made me laugh.
Yeah, coon incidents.
Where I was like, this coffee's not going down my throat.
Boy.
Can anyone think of any other ones?
I'm sure we'll come up with a few.
Yeah. No,
Scott, but what are you doing? You're making me nervous.
Some folk singer just reneged.
Neg. E.
Re-neg.
E, you fucking tool. E. Re-noggin. Re-noogin.
Yeah, and before every podcast, someone should get Joe irritated. He was irritated from the beginning.
I'm irritated because we started 30 minutes late.
Yeah, why?
We're testing the... Why?
Yeah. Tell us.
It's fucking... It's somebody's time. It's very rude.
Yeah.
It's very, very rude. And I'm not blaming anyone other than Bobby and Chris and you.
Right. What? I was here on time.
Yeah, you're guest hosting.
Yeah, I was
so
here.
So you're the host. Mind
those so what does that mean? Am I responsible for Chris Scopo?
You're responsible for
what's
the show.
What's his name
you're
again?
Hosting
Scopo.
The show.
Scopo.
I did that on purpose. Yeah.
Dance hall booty.
You know, he gets a little too big for his britches once in a while. For once in a while, we should just forget his last name. I think that's what he deserves. But what was your
name? I think everyone forgot my last name.
Chris Scobo?
What's going on with you there, Scobo? You're like shitting on yourself?
Yeah, you're all right.
Okay, yeah, what's your name?
Dude, you should be
Scobo. Wearing... Don't try to get out of this beating right here.
He's trying to do Eminem and 8 Mile where he like shits on himself so then they have nothing else
to say. Yes, I do have a big butt, and I am from Queens. And Kelly Fustuca does do a better job on the cameras than me.
And that doesn't...
But I know something about you. You're in love with a beautiful woman. I'm all, oh, Jesus, take it away on my power.
We're inside the ring. Giannis is working on a new laugh.
Joe, you're an asshole. You know that? What do you mean I'm an asshole? I'm having fun. You're dumb.
Huh? Let me renig. Fucking get on the comment
you're
board.
You're still
people...
working the renig angle? Oh,
no, because you called me dumb because of renig. A lot of people say renig. It's like slang. That's it's like saying
re-African American.
It's slang for fucking.
I prefer recolored. This is what Joe does to be an asshole. Yeah. He's the nicest guy in the world.
Thank you.
He'll slowly do this, and then you'll be like, this is him being a dick.
He'll be like, I wrote a new bit about you. I got a bit where I'm like, you ever notice when your friends are so inconsiderate and selfish? And you're like, what?
Wait, tell him what you did.
Joe? That's your Joe impression? Yeah.
Tell him
what's your Joe impression?
I don't have one.
It's a Boston impression.
Yeah. Tell him what you did, though. I was not a bad Joe listening person.
I wanted to write a bit about you, but he did something.
The blinks help it.
You walked in, and you were like, I had a terrible day. I was like, oh, this just happened.
That's what Soda does. And he makes... Now, your way of making me an asshole is reporting me. I literally go like this. I'm like, I just had the worst day. And Soda's like, me too. I fucking got fired from a... Immediately just takes it off. I don't even get a
moment.
He's more
important than you are.
Yeah, but you know, I don't know if that's true. That's comics in general. Most comics do that.
Thank you, Lewis.
Most comics, because we're about ourselves all the time.
Sam listens, though. He does listen with his
mouth
open.
Sam's a great listener.
Trying to figure out what it's like to be human.
I don't like you guys blaming his, saying he's a good listener because he's partially retarded. That's not fair.
Sam's half retarded and the other half
is water.
I'm getting a lot of credit for my learning disability.
You sit there
He goes, yeah.
Huh? Sam's half Jewish, half retarded, and half idiot.
Oh boy, where's the bandana for that one?
You know what? Dude, give me the.
That was a room style.
I had the wig.
I had my mouth open, ready for that one, Joe.
Bomb wig.
There you go. There's your dream. You could be my sidekick now, Maurice and the Boston guy.
Boston Joe.
He looks like a shitty toupee right now.
He looks like what's his name from the American Hustle a little bit.
Oh shit.
But Christian Bale, I forget the character's name. Not a great movie.
The best scope, joke Scopo's ever told, and he didn't even have the name or the reference.
He's like the guy in the thing. This is good.
I'm throwing out one or two zingers, especially in Lewis's direction.
I think he's just savoring this time away from Kelly.
Yeah. It is fucking.
I mean, we got a month away from Kelly. She's going away tomorrow.
Is it a whole month?
It's a whole month. We have.
Could somebody bomb because this is making my head itch.
It's fucking hilarious.
You have to wear it.
You don't have to wear it. Well, I'm a team player because I care about other people, unlike you.
Whoa!
Oh, wow. Joe, you're not the greatest guy in the world. Let's be honest.
Okay. Joe, no, I disagree. I think Joe's one of the nicest.
He's a good person.
He's a good person.
I do volunteer work. What do you do?
I don't do it, but I did 9/11 disaster relief for 2.5 years. I helped people.
Two and a half years? You should have done a better job. That's way too long.
What?
Keep that wig on.
Too long.
Someone get a staple gun so it can be permanent.
All right.
You mean hand the wig to me.
I think you mean permanent. Because he fucks up his E's and I's. What are you guys, bailing on me?
I mean pigment.
Guys.
Boy, oh boy. And then he talks about how people from Boston are racist. He said nig 354 times already.
But he's from
already.
Brooklyn.
I'm from Brooklyn. I'm allowed to do that. Right.
But Joe, you are a good person, though. You do Buddhism. You volunteer.
I do Buddhism. That's true.
I go around, practice Buddhism.
I go around doing Buddhism.
Yeah, no, you're right,
I tried to give him a compliment. I can't even take a compliment. I was trying to give him a compliment. I fucking messed up the grammar.
Do you mean a compliment? Yeah.
Well, I care about...
You're going to make fucking Mercury Rising over here, his autistic joke-telling ability.
Jesus Christ.
Just slamming his head, a hand into his head.
This episode, we're going to see how many ways we can get racial slurs into words.
words, do you mean Jews?
I saved you on that one.
I only went because Joe went.
Yeah, I fucking saved your ass. You owe me one now. Maybe you could invite me to your son's second birthday party, you fucking jerk off.
Like he's going to be around for that.
Well, we'll see. We'll see how involved you are in his life over the next year, Joe.
Well, invite me to come play with him and finger him and shit. I want to play with him. I love your kid. What, are you kidding? Did I hung out with him one time. I saw him. I picked him up.
Did you really want to go?
Of course, I would have gone. I would have appreciated the invite, and I would have gone.
I didn't want to make it a big thing, and then I didn't want to be in a situation where I was inviting. Then I have to invite fucking.
You just want to invite people that can help your career, so, Dan Soder.
That's not true.
So I'll tell you this.
Seems like it.
Who was invited? I see
an enemy. Fastuca, Dan, Dave Smith.
Whoa, that's.
Never mind. Sorry, I take it back.
No, yeah. But Fastuca babysits James all the time.
On the reg.
And Dave is like, your basically, fucking. Yeah.
Your good
James
friend.
James' uncle, and Soder's fucking.
Is that your baby's
really
name, James?
Help me with my career.
He knows I got a little money, so I'm going to bring a present.
Is your baby's name James?
Yeah.
Okay. Sweet baby.
He doesn't
James.
Even know your baby's name, this fucking asshole.
I'm being honest.
I'm telling you, though, good hang, because I got there early, so I got to hang with Louis, Dave, Beatrice, and James, and then all the family came.
Who is Beatrice?
And I had to leave, so, but it was good. It was good. I don't like, you know, you can't be.
Appreciate you giving us that play by play there.
It was raining.
Yeah. What time was it about?
It was around. I got there around 3:39 p.m.
You have a nice cup of coffee before you work.
Yeah,
yeah. So I got 16 text messages from Soder because he was standing outside of my apartment in the rain, and I didn't fucking leave my phone.
This is
on
what
me.
Lewis does. He just texts you his address like we live in the fucking suburbs. There's apartment numbers. Yeah. I get there, it's pouring rain. I keep calling Lewis's phone, and then I have to ask the guy in his building. I'm like, you know what? Apartment Lewis and Beatrice.
You know where that guy lives? He looks like a police sketch when he has his hood on. Where does he live at?
You know that guy you're terrified of when he comes in your building?
It's like he's horrible. He just points everywhere.
Lewis walks like he's looking for somebody.
He looks.
Doesn't he?
He always looks like he dropped his keys.
Yeah.
He's got that determined look on his face. He's like, I was walking down this street. Okay, I turned right here.
To me, he looks like, are you the guy? Are you the guy? Yeah. He's just looking around looking for a guy.
He's got revenge face.
Yeah.
Thanks. Yeah, you're welcome. Yeah.
I mean, you're an animal. That's just how it is. Lewis the animal steel.
Joe, are you comfortable?
Scopo's making me unbelievably uncomfortable. He keeps getting up and walking behind me. I don't know what the hell's going on.
He's the lighting course. Scopo, do you have another fucking herpes, dude?
No, it was a fucking pimple I popped it.
You have herpes too?
No, I don't have herpes too.
No, herpes simplex too.
No, but you have herpes?
Yes, herpes 3.
I gave you that one, Joe. You got out of that one.
Joe, you're
Indiana Jones.
Off the side here.
Indiana Jones right under that one.
Joe, don't get irrigated.
Get a what?
Irrigated.
Don't get irrigated.
Don't get irrigated.
How the fuck do you have a morning show? You can't even talk.
Yeah, Giannis and his smart words. Seriously, though, you get very irrigated.
After 9 a.m., Giannis' brain shuts down.
Yeah, that's true. I'm not used to
you that. But fucking 5 a.m., it's
Wepa, Wepa, Wepa! Hey, good morning, Miami! Outside it's cha-cha-cha-cha-cha-cha!
Whatever fucking Univision bullshit you do in the mornings of Miami.
Buenos tardes.
Giannis' nombre es Giannis Papi.
By the way, Giannis said the word millennials 15 times the other day. It made me furious.
That's because I was trying to help you understand the business, because I understand it like little Duval does.
What the hell is millennials?
Millennials are people born in 1980.
And most of them are
not all of them.
Welcome to the NAACP approved
NAACP.
If they listen to this podcast, they'd be like, how is it going? This is called a white guy finger.
Kelly's in studio. She's on the podcast, by the way.
Thank God.
I hope.
Is she listening live? She's going to be pissed.
Is she going to be pissed?
Kelly will make a great manager. I mean, quote, unquote, Kelly will make a great manager.
First of all, Kelly wouldn't make a great manager. Nobody likes her. You have to like your manager.
No, I think that was a polite way of saying she's never going to make it in this business.
I didn't say that.
Well, what does that imply?
I said she's going to make it in this business as a manager.
You're right. Not true, dude.
What happened, Louis? Yo, that's God giving you that.
Dude, it's
God,
possible.
God owes you about 49 more of those.
Don't you think if Kelly cleaned up a little bit, you know what I mean? Tightened up a little bit,
her
cleaned
body?
Up, she got on the girl code, it could happen.
Yeah, you're
yeah.
Right. The girl code really is a knighting.
Yeah,
stranger shit
really
has happened.
Yeah, well, it could get you on. I mean, it's like, all they edit you nice, you know? You just say a couple of quips.
Yeah. And you sell out comedy clubs.
Yeah, that's it.
That's yeah, make your ex-boyfriend really jealous and bitter. make him move to Miami and give up on his real career.
Almost go goddamn suicidal.
Start smoking cigarettes and everyone's Joe like, oh, Giannis, you look great. You lost so much weight. He's like, yeah, dude, I stopped eating and just smoking just four packs
eat.
A day.
Yeah, I smoke cigarettes and don't
I
eat.
I just sit in an unfurnished apartment in Miami with the windows.
I'm on the diet called thinking of her.
Yeah, I just imagine him sitting on the floor, hardwood floors. Yeah. There's no blinds up.
I just pace in my apartment. I might as well just go smoke a cigarette,
should
do
be,
something.
Should be here any day.
Yeah, it's not lonely down here at all. Not lonely. Let me see if I can call John Moses. Let me just go through the J's and see what friends I have with letter J. What's up, Moses? How's it going? Yeah, I know I've never called you ever. Just want to check in.
Just want to rap.
Yeah,
you
call me, buddy.
You go to bed at fucking 8 p.m. every night, just sad, not doing comedy, getting up at 4.
It's fucking hard, man. You can call me anytime, Giannis.
I just
call me anytime, buddy.
Me too. I put it out there, man.
Yeah, okay.
Text me first.
I will, guys. Yeah.
If you could text me first.
No, me and Joe, we're good friends, man. I feel like we're friends
pretty
now.
Pretty close? Yeah, I think so. Yeah. Certainly closer than Lewis and I are.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, that's
if I was
evident,
to rank
yeah.
my friends in this in order, I would say Dan Soder, Sam Morril, right. Giannis, Lewis.
Four. Scopo doesn't exist.
Scopo didn't even make the cut.
Made the cut on that one. I always think that you're Robbie Bernstein. Are you not the same guy?
Robbie Bernstein, another comedian.
Why would you do that, honestly? That's like a Kelly Pastuca-esque kind of dig at me.
Oh!
Pastuca-esque!
Kelly ain't even here to defend himself!
Everybody laughed!
Is this the opposite of name dropping? What are we doing?
His name picking up. Where's Bobby? What is Bobby doing now?
Eating.
No grains, dude!
No grains!
I think he's in Boston, actually. He's
great town. Wonderful town.
You still do that 12-minute bit about how you hate it?
Yeah, well, yeah. Still got it in the rotation, yeah. Okay, Matt Damon was here last night at the Comedy Cellar.
He's a nice guy. He's friends with Tom.
You got that feeling, too.
You guys aren't reading this.
Reading what?
The chat. I don't know.
Kelly Pastuca. They're not reading this. Don't be sad, Giannis. You the shit.
Oh, my
God. No. She said you duh shit.
Oh, yeah, duh shit.
Hold on. She wants us to read her shitty quips.
She's got more here. I'm listening, and I hate all of you.
Okay.
Hello, someone notice me. I'm sick.
Oh, can I just say she always kisses Giannis' ass.
Giannis and Bobby. You ever realize that?
She's like, Oh,
Yanni, you're so talented, Yanni.
Giannis got on TV, and then all of a sudden, she's like, oh, maybe I can get on TV one
why
time.
Soda's on real TV, and she doesn't kiss his ass.
I'm not in Univision's minor leagues. I'm on MTV, too. That's true.
You can actually find his channel.
Barely.
Yeah, you want to watch my show? Go to fusion.net.
Yeah.
We couldn't even afford a .com.
Giannis is so talented. Oh, Giannis, you're here. I love Giannis.
Your Kelly sounds a little bit like Mrs. Doubtfire.
I'll be your new nanny. My name's Kelly Pastuca.
She's going to miss his Doubtfire her comedy career.
Hello!
She can get the wigs from Giannis, though.
Hey! Scobo! 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 Scobo!
Wow!
Scobo's on the board!
Scobo! Wow! Holy shit! Yeah, I do. Boy, that was like a finger in the asshole. I really didn't think I was going to like it, but I loved it. That was great. Boy, oh boy. Who likes eating asshole? Have we talked about this on the show?
I love it.
I love it.
No, I think a lot of people pretend that they do, but they don't.
But I don't go
really?
Yeah. Hold on. Pretend that they love eating or kidding.
Yeah, they pretend that they do, and nobody really does.
Are you crazy?
It's a place where shit comes out.
I don't stick my tongue in the
You gotta go on like this.
Yeah. Swipe it.
Okay, first of all, this is the truth.
Nice. I eat pussy from behind, by the way.
I never seen that.
You lay your nose right up at the top like you're looking over a cliff.
Yeah, I'm the neighbor at Home Improvement.
Wilson.
Yeah, Mr. Wilson.
Hey, that's Dennis the Menace. Wilson, just Wilson.
It's just Wilson.
Like you're a cartoon and half your head is just peeking up over a movie letter.
Yeah.
By the way, this effect, kissing a girl with tongue is dirtier than licking her asshole.
Okay, thanks.
Yeah, I don't buy that. There's more bacteria.
You guys made a lot of talking over each other happening, guys. Let's take it easy.
There's a lot of bacteria in your mouth that you don't have the same type of bacteria in your asshole. I'm telling you.
Really?
It's cleaner to lick an asshole. Look it up.
Really?
I understand you're telling us. I like that people just say, I'm telling you.
Yeah.
I know that you're telling me. That doesn't mean it's right.
Doesn't make sense.
Shit comes out of the ass. Yeah. The seeds and
do you know what happens when you don't wipe your ass and you know it like burns and gets red? Yeah, that's because the bacteria fucking burns your skin.
It's hepatitis A, bro.
Yeah. I mean, that's shit is poking.
Can somebody look it up? What's cleaner, an asshole or a mouth?
That's why it smells, because it's telling you to stay
away
from it.
Why would that even be?
It's dangerous.
A mouth or an asshole?
Maybe Kelly can do that.
Yeah.
Dude, Lewis, where'd you get this fact? Where'd you read it?
Snapple? Somewhere.
Somewhere.
Read it up. Scrub it. Look up the facts.
What do you want to look up?
Guys, let me just say this.
It has to.
When has somewhere ever been wrong?
Somewhere. I'm going to look it up. I read it somewhere.
I heard it somewhere.
Wait, guys. It's time to read a compliment to Giannis from Kelly.
I like all of your characters. I think they're all equally potent.
Because Giannis is nice to me. You dumb heads.
All right, don't get too confident. Read it in a voice.
I went into the voice, was like, I can't do it. Yeah, I just didn't sound with it.
Just stick with that queen, should be a cab
driver
voice.
I don't have voices like you, Giannis. I'm sorry.
I know. Or talent.
That's why.
Or
that. at least my girlfriend didn't leave me for fame.
We got a real Sam and Diane thing going here.
At least I had a girlfriend who was hot who fucked me. You got one of those?
Mine's pretty hot.
She's good looking.
Yeah.
All right. Well, don't introduce her to me because that would be
not great. Because what? She'll leave you afterwards?
Yeah. Because she'll be like, you know what? I can date a guy with a normal lower body. That's weird.
I don't have to date centaurs.
And a baguette's the upper body.
Yeah. I do not have that anymore.
Yeah, because your sadness and smoking whittled you down to just the bone structure.
Scopo, I cannot say anything about Jessie May because you used to hand out flyers for her.
Yeah,
I'm not saying anything bad about her. You were employed by her pre-girl code.
Lewis, let this happen.
He was employed by her pre-girl code.
Was that one and one?
Yeah. One and one, yeah.
When she was a nice, normal human?
Yeah. Honest Dan tonight.
I told you, man.
It's like joke, honest fact.
That joke was
Kelly! She's never going to make it in this business.
I didn't say that!
I love Kelly.
Okay, by the way, this is on Wiki Answers, so somebody wrote it, but this is what they're talking about. The human anus or butt is actually cleaner. The mouth excretes germs and bacteria of a more potent manner. But beware of the fact that you are more likely to get sick from having someone's anus in your mouth than having someone spit in your mouth.
That's the opposite of what you said, Lewis.
No, it's not.
Yeah, you said you're more likely to get... Say it again. Repeat it.
You're more likely to get sick. You're not going to get pink eye from making out with someone. Yeah.
Don't re-African-American on this.
Yeah, don't re-nag.
I like that we're either all talking or nobody talking.
Well, because we're waiting for Lewis to repeat it.
I'm pulling a different one up, because that one's not...
So you're going to go to yahoo.answers now?
I repeat it.
Oh, okay. Push it or not?
You're going to go see what ask...
But no one answers.
.com?
What do you guys doing?
What do I feel about
you? What do you mean everybody?
Big fan of it.
DeSoto gave his technique and everything. His preference, he likes to eat from behind, perch his nose over the top.
Love that shit.
I like to... Did it this morning. Give a couple of little
breakfast, cereal and ass.
American,
dog drinking water.
I'd like to do it post shower though. I don't think you don't dirt the butt. I want to clean it and then get it.
Yeah, but you clean it with your
How fastidious.
I don't, but I assume
don't die, bro. Don't die.
I think it means whatever you're not.
I don't even think Jonathan. Fucking day calendar of words.
Dude, nobody eats ass as much as they say they do.
I don't
eat
a brat.
Yeah, it's a brat. It's like one of those things.
If my girl would let me eat her ass, I'd eat her ass every time.
I'd feel the same way.
Every fucking time.
I believe you, but I don't believe those guys.
Fuck you!
I don't believe you guys.
I told you this morning I had a little taste.
Don't do that. Don't do that, because this is what Giannis does. He tries to start dumb arguments that you can't prove. He's one of those guys that just says you're lying.
You're right.
When it's just a fucking...
It's called starting something. Entertaining, Joe. Instead of just being irritated that we fucking started 30 minutes late and hating everybody.
Don't irritate. Entertain.
Entertake? Look, that's a Giannis
word. Not my fault. You got a barber's haircut from 1930.
You look like you're a nice haircut.
Yeah, I'm gonna stop you right there. Joe's haircut, flowing and beautiful.
Yeah but that hair looks like he's a fisticuffer from the 1930s or a bartender or a barber.
Pugilist is probably the word you wanted.
Giannis's haircut is 60s accountant.
Giannis' haircut, very similar to Joe's.
Yeah, you're the only guy with a comb over who has
a bard in the middle of that.
You really do. You have bigger than McCracken before he lost.
Only Giannis would try to come at my hair. I got fucking horrible teeth, herpes, no jaw. You're like, look at this hair on this guy. I have golden hair.
You're going after the one strand on his face.
Forehead, I can't see anything. I got my teeth.
Teeth are staring right out of
my
you.
Nephew,
go for his fucking hair.
But we've covered all that already.
My nephew asked me why my teeth are yellow.
Your nephew did?
Yeah, I told him because Santa Claus isn't real.
Are we allowed to do bits on this show?
Dude, that's not a bit. He did a bit earlier.
Dude, what he just said about my hair is the funniest fucking thing anyone's ever said about my hair.
What?
That I'm the only dude with hair who has a comb over.
Oh, boy.
Just the way my hair grows, I guess.
Lewis, anything? You want to jump in?
Yeah.
No, I'm waiting. No. Okay. still nervously chewing gum like a college basketball coach? Trying to see if that 2-3 is going to work?
Still figuring out how you can prove that the mouth is dirtier than the ass.
Can somebody in the fucking chat room please send us information what is more bacteria, the ass or the mouth?
Kelly,
that's one
send
of the most
picture.
Ridiculous assertions you could ever make.
No,
the asshole is the dirtiest part of the body. That's why shit smells.
That's why your hands are dirtier than your ass, you idiot.
No way.
Do you know how much shit you touch all day? Shit.
Dude. I could shake his hand and probably like eat a piece of pizza with my hands after nothing happened. Yeah. If I took my hand
every meal
and
I've ever eaten.
Dug it in his ass,
you're an idiot.
Or put
First
it on
of all,
his
there's
asshole.
There's feces in and everything we eat. Dude, there's people put their fingers in their asses and touch every surface. You've all ass bacteria is all over everything.
I don't like pop up Lewis facts. He's just like, you know that the mouth is dirtier than the asshole. You know if you eat everything you eat has poop in it.
But the ass only exists to dispose of the waste.
Yeah,
that's the whole ass's thing. It's just the bad shit. It's in the ass.
Garbage.
That's what an asshole is.
It's not like you're sucking on my colon, dude. It's your fucking ass meat. You can lick a little ass meat and not get sick. I've never gotten sick.
God,
from eating ass meat.
Ass meat?
I haven't either. That's not the argument. The argument is that it's dirtier than a mouth, which seems sick.
Ass meat.
Kelly, send us a picture of your asshole and mouth.
Kelly did say to Joe.
Uh-oh.
She said, fuck them, Joe. I'd sit on those teeth.
Oh. Well, you might get cut up a little bit if you did that. Like sitting on a shark's face.
One of those reverse tire things at the end where you can't drive over one way.
Is that a thing? Sitting on teeth? Oh, sit on my teeth, baby.
Ass meat sounds like a Mauricia term.
Yo, you need to get my ass meat. Yeah. That's what I'm trying to tell you. Gotta get this ass pussy meat. That's it. Hey.
How are you doing a bad Mauricia? That seems weird.
Give me another beer.
Oh, God. Oh, boy. Get Giannis a beer. Sam, get
I'm
a beer.
I'm telling you, Mauricio Dangerfield.
Yeah, I like that one.
I'll have a beer. Fuck it.
Your ass puts your way.
Yeah, don't try to go to Westchester. I'm telling you. Wiper.
Let's get Sam some booze. Oh, Sam gets really fun when he's
Sam's got an unbelievable chest. Sam looks like he's got Dave Smith body, like super skinny, but his chest is out of this world.
I do a great Sam impression.
Do it.
That's pretty good.
What
pretty
is that?
Good.
I didn't get that.
Couldn't see in
the camera. It's my posture.
Can you do it? Sit it down. Can you do it sitting down? Yeah. Wait, like, okay, that's good.
Holds the mic.
That looks
here.
Like a sleepy baby.
You guys fucking watch Sam's act like I do.
And then he always like readjusts his stand. You know, he like readjusts that stand after the joke.
Yeah. Yeah. I like when he says joke. Yeah.
Yeah.
And after a bomb, he always does another bomb. Yeah. I've noticed.
Oh. I think that's mean.
It was a joke.
Okay, Kelly chimed in by the way with the whole ass mouth thing.
Good.
She said the answer is more germs in the mouth. However, it takes years for those germs to affect you.
Okay, thank you, Kelly. Right. So Lewis's argument
is still wrong.
Boy, I'm in trouble then.
Now, how am I still wrong? All I said was there was more bacteria in the mouth than there was in the ass.
No, you didn't say that.
That's not what you said.
What
you said
say?
It's you get sick. There's a better chance of getting sick from making out with someone than licking ass. That's exactly what you said.
Actually, I will stand by that statement.
Yeah, that's what you said.
You get sick? Yeah, there's a million different things you can get sick by kissing somebody in the mouth.
True.
And there's almost nothing you get sick from licking somebody.
I'm not going to lie. I take Lewis's side of this.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Well, and Jester Skulls wrote in, even if the mouth mouth has more bacteria, it's probably not as detrimental as the bacteria in your ass.
Ooh, good point.
Thank you, Dr. Jester Skull.
First of all, I know Jester Skulls. He's been on my show before. Matt, go fuck yourself. You're like 19 and your girlfriend's cheating on you.
Whoa! What did you guys take some truth serum before this episode?
What's that thing that they give you where you have to say everything? That episode drugs.
Jesus Christ!
Why would you say that to him, man? He's a fan.
No, I'm sorry, she is.
Because he's Lewis the Animal Steel. I'm gonna introduce him like that the next time I'm hosting on stage. Coming to the stage, giving up everybody for Lewis J. Gomez the Animal Steel.
That doesn't make sense though. You're supposed to say Lewis the
I
Animal Steel.
I fucked it up, Lewis the Animal Steel. Yeah.
Solid copy.
Blew it.
I just didn't want to make him angry because he wants the J always in there.
Which is retarded.
It's the most ironic thing in the world.
Time out. You really think that's retarded?
Yeah, because if someone said, I'm going to introduce you to my friend Lewis J. Gomez, and then you walked in, you'd be like, wait a second.
Okay, but no, until I get to the level where fucking that's just Louis C.K. is at, or fucking anybody
but
else.
But Lewis Gomez.
Yeah, Lewis Gomez.
It's a great name. That's a great
name.
Yeah, but there's 150 other people with that name. But you're not putting J. Lewis
First of all,
Gomez.
There's way more than 150 Lewis Gomez.
I'm saying if you Google
there's
Lewis
150
Gomez.
Lewis Gomez is in one tenement in Brooklyn.
At the time when I started performing, if you Google Lewis Gomez, there was going to be, there's like 18 baseball
how
players
many,
named Lewis Gomez.
But how many Lewis Gomez are running LOL comedy?
Zero.
Nobody confuses
Beatrice
you.
LaBarge nobody is running LOL comedy. Yeah, nobody, and everyone knows that.
Nobody confuses you with the other Lewis Gomez.
Yes, you're never doing the show again.
Don't you try to fool me. Beatrice is Jack Tunney. I know, really, it's Vince McMahon running things. I know, it's not. He's not the president of the WWF.
There's no other comedians named Lewis Gomez. There's no confusion.
Actually, there is.
Yeah, is there?
Who's that fat guy that was on...
Lewis J. Gomez.
No. Yeah, well, of course.
On Access? On Live at Goth? On Gotham Live?
He's been in a bunch of Adam Sandler movies.
Louis Guzman.
Louis Guzman.
All right, I'll give you the joke.
There's an L.A. comic named Lewis Gomez, and it's just such a common name. Like Dave Smith should have went with Dave A. Smith years ago. Now it's just too late. Yeah. Dave Smith. There's 8 comics named Dave Smith.
It's a made up name. And you're like, what's your friend name?
Because this is a business, dude. It's a fucking business. I'm gonna open a deli named fucking Katz's Deli across the street from Katz's Deli.
Giannis knows it's a business. He lives in Miami and drives a Mercedes.
Whatever. He does is he lives in business.
That's because I understand the business like Lil Duval.
Yeah. Because he has demographic charts.
Wrote me a help room with my fire.
Lewis does research, just like you do, Lewis.
Joseph, like
and also
Joseph
the
A. List. What do you think?
Yeah. I am Joseph A. List. If I've ever made like a movie, like a drama, yeah. Call it a Joseph A. List picture.
I think it's a classy move. William H. Macy.
What's your middle name?
E.
So you'd be Samuel E.
Abraham.
Giannis, what goofy Greek letter does your middle name start
He's
with?
He's always off by a letter.
It's a Y with two lines at the bottom.
Off by a letter with always racism.
My racism has been off by one letter today.
Abraham, not Abraham.
Abraham or something like that.
Giannis.
Papas. Mine's even worse. Frederikos Christos.
Yeah, of course it is.
Giannis
FC Pappas. Sounds like a sandwich at a diner.
Wow. It sounds like
I'll take that wig.
But when I started doing comedy.
Sounds like a sandwich in a diner.
You got too excited for it.
But by the time I started doing comedy, I had already like been practicing my signature since I was like 4 years old as Lewis J. Gomez.
What?
You blew my real ass dudeness? Okay.
That was great.
Okay, Dan.
Dude, so, you can't, that's illegal. You cannot boo his real ass dude.
So by the time I grew up, I'd been signing it like that. So am I going to sign Lewis J. Gomez and just be Lewis Gomez?
Yeah, you're not allowed to have a middle initial if you're Puerto Rican. I'll take that wig back.
Yep, there we go. That was a fun stay.
Are you implying that was a joke?
Do it in character.
Wait, this is
you're
going
not
out
supposed
on
to have a little letter if you're Puerto Rican.
What's Maurice's middle name?
Marisa Classy Rodriguez.
You didn't think that far ahead? You didn't think that far ahead? She doesn't have a middle name? Come on, bro. You're an actor. You're supposed to fucking live the character. You're supposed to know what she had for breakfast that day. Ass pussy?
What would be your middle name?
Let's figure it out right now.
My middle name, Elias.
Ah,
that's a good one. Named after the general platoon.
No,
I made that up. It's not
it's
really.
Nate after.
I was almost. I'm so gullible.
It was Elias who beget Abraham, who beget the son of David.
You're bigot. Beget you, yeah. Bigot is the word you're looking for.
Beget.
Begot.
Beget. This racism thing is weird. Bigot. Beget. Bigot. Bigot Abraham.
Begot.
What's middle name? What's the middle name?
Edward Richard.
Oh, that's as white as it gets.
Are you giving you a confirmation name, too, or are you giving him a middle
name? My name's Dan. What is it again?
Edward Richard.
My name's Dan. Edward
two middle names.
Daniel.
Daniel Edward Richard Silver.
And the Edward Richard, it's hyphenated.
This is three white guy names in a row.
Actually, it's my great-great-grandfather, my great-grandfather, my grandfather, then my father. That's how it goes. In order. You fucking asshole.
Who are you? Joe Liz now?
You're
fucking asshole.
Giannis Tzatziki Sauce Pappas.
Look at Joe's calmed down now. So more sedate.
Very calm. I'm doing Buddhist.
You've really calmed down. You settled in. You were a little irritated at the beginning.
You push buttons, buddy.
It was me that pushed the buttons.
You always push buttons.
Why is that?
You're a provocateur.
You
like
do you secretly really hate me?
I love you.
No, seriously.
I love you the most.
Do you think so?
What? I think you're great.
I think you're super.
I think that you're a little less wise than you imply.
What do you mean I imply? I don't imply that
then
I'm wise.
Then people think.
Yeah, so why are you mad at me about that?
People, I'm not mad at you.
Yeah.
I love you.
So why would you even bring that up? You just said I'm a little less wise than I imply. When do I ever imply that I'm wise?
You try to use big words and you use them wrong.
I haven't used one word wrong today.
Renig?
Renig is the colloquialism for reneg.
You just said colloquialism.
Colloquialism.
And
everybody knows it is reneg, right?
Everybody can phone jail.
That's how you say it.
Right fucking now.
That's how I said it in New York. You say you reneged on the deal.
Some people in
you reneged on the deal.
Oh,
that is true.
Yes.
Yeah, when he said reneged on
dude.
The deal. Yeah.
You, anyone reneged on the deal? Ask anyone in the chat room, they know what I'm talking about. Because Joe Liz hates me and had it out for me, he pointed it out. Because you do hate me.
Are there any other ignorant people in the chat room who misuse words?
I think that you're great.
I'm sorry.
I care about African Americans, so I don't appreciate you misenunciating.
You do not care about African Americans.
I think you're great. We've had so many heart to hearts. I wish that we would talk more. I care about your well-being. It makes me worried that you're still up in arms about this silly girl who doesn't even care about you.
Who said I was still up in arms? I'm getting accused of a bunch of stuff
I've
that hasn't happened.
I've never hung out with you when you didn't bring it up.
Look, I'm
gonna
call.
I haven't hung out with you in 3-4 months.
Dude,
you
I'm gonna call Jesse right now. Let's just hash this out. Where's my phone?
What do you?
I'm gonna call Jesse on speaker.
Number she's three talking. On speed dial.
You could ask her about boning Pete Davidson.
Dude,
I did do that.
I joked that she boned Pete Davidson on a show months and months and months ago, and then Giannis was drunk like 2 weeks ago. I get a text at 2 a.m.
It's like a month
ago.
Hey,
did Jesse really bone Pete Davidson? But in Pete's defense, he does look like a guy that would sleep with one of his teachers.
Yeah.
That kid, like when they'd show, you'd be
oh,
like,
absolutely.
You'd be like, this 29-year-old Texas high school teacher had sex with her students. A picture of Pete, his dumb lips. He's like,
I just know that at 19, he would not be able to control himself. Remember 19, dude? 20? Yeah. When you just like was sitting in math class and like just fucking
you were taking
look
math
at
class at 20?
Well, yeah.
You were in math class?
Yeah, I went to college.
From Brooklyn, so.
Yeah, me too. And I didn't have to take
oh,
a
I'm
math
sorry.
Class.
You're from Queens. I forgot. You're from such a
yeah,
classier
I'm
area.
I'm saying we're dumb. That's what I'm saying.
Oh,
yeah.
Look at that. You really threw your fucking big dick Brooklyn out there. Yeah. Oh, I'm sorry. I'm from Brooklyn. Where are you from? You're from Queens? Manhattan over here, Sam Morril. Yeah. Doesn't say anything.
Provocateur.
Provocateur.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. I forgot you're from Queens, you piece of shit.
Well, I thought he was taking a dig at me being from Brooklyn. I'm like, oh,
no,
yeah,
we're
you
both
know.
From fucking the boroughs.
We're both from the boroughs, yeah.
All right. Well, Sam's from the main island, so why don't you get mad at him?
Yeah, well.
And Lewis is from the forest north of the city.
You think of like Manhattan as like a borough.
Lewis is from
you think of the city.
Yeah.
You always think of it as the city.
As a city.
You never think of Manhattan as a borough. You think of it as a city and then the rest of them are boroughs.
And then Lewis is from the wolf conclave upstate.
I was born into darkness.
You've merely adopted it. I was born into it. Molded by it. I didn't see society when I was already a real ass dude. And by then it was blinding. LOL. This comedy show belongs to you. He's the bane of LOL. Mr. List. Are you ready for your spot?
Oh man, how's things going with you, Joe?
What like you, an awful
man.
Segue!
Yeah, you really turned to Charlie Rose there. Yeah,
that's a good interview question.
Wow, what a barn burn!
Fucking Bobby does a really good job of keeping this thing moving,
yeah,
doesn't he?
Great,
he's
unbelievable,
oh, God,
great host. What yes. time is he getting here?
He's not coming today.
Oh,
what's that doing?
Things are great with me. Yeah. Thanks for asking why we're on the podcast.
You know what? Wait a minute. Hold on. It's New Year's. Why don't we fucking do New Year's resolutions and what happened this year?
I got a good game.
What's your game?
You know, it's the rose thorn. What's that one?
Oh, boo.
The thorn.
It's a bunch of boo.
Every rose has its thorn.
Rose thorn seed.
Every rose has its thorn. Just like every cowboy has its thorn. Just like every cowboy sings a sad song. Every rose has its thorn.
Lewis, what's your favorite band of all time?
It's been a while now, and I feel still so much pain.
Watch this. You really want to laugh? Lewis, what's your favorite?
Like a knife that punctures the wound heals, but the scar, that scar remains.
My first two concerts, Poison concerts.
Lewis, who's your favorite band of all time?
My favorite band of all time, Skid Row.
Oh, that's so funny to me.
Why?
Sam, do you want to hear about the game? Sam, you fucking human.
It's heavy metal, Skid Row.
It's like, yeah.
You gentlemen and scholar, human.
You know Skid Row.
Weird shoulders.
You've gone wild?
How's the song go?
They call us Problem Child. We are the youth gone wild. Whoa.
Giannis, you can
I like that Lewis brought up the New Year's resolution thing, and Joe can't get this fucking thing out. So just say it.
No, I just want to see more 80s metal.
If you want to see Skid Row, just check your local carnivals.
State fairs?
Yeah, they might be playing a tent next to the bearded lady.
All right,
Joe.
What's your New Year's resolution, guys?
Oh, he has a game.
I got a fucking game, fuck.
Federico Papusa.
Federico Papusa.
This is what Giannis did. Giannis accuses people of claiming they like to eat ass when they don't. But then he'll do his thing where he's like, Skid Row, I never heard of him. I'm hood. I'm black. All I know is hip-hop.
I don't know Skid Row.
I've never heard of Skid Row. You've never heard of Skid Row once.
Giannis, you were a senior in high school when they were popular.
You never heard of Skid Row?
When Giannis was 18 in 1986, they were pretty big.
How old are you, Giannis?
26. I'm in my 30s, Joe.
Are you?
Giannis said turn that racket down when they had their number one album.
They're playing that rock and roll music.
It's the devil's music.
All right, Joe, what's your game?
All right, it is Rose, Thorn, Seed. You go through the year. You pick your thorn. That was the negative part of the year. Least favorite, the shitty part. The thorn. It's a, you know, analogy. Like, stab you in the thumb.
That's a good one. This
the
is a good one.
The seed, well, that will go last. The rose is the nicest part, the best part, the part you enjoyed the most. And then the seed is what you're looking forward to that stemmed from this year.
That's a good game. I like
good game.
You guys so want to start with Sammy?
We can start with rose, or we can start with thorn.
I still start with thorn.
Thorn.
Let's go thorn.
So that's the bad thing from this year.
Your least favorite thing, which we all know you fucking.
Lewis, the animal steel.
That's my thorn for this year right there. Lewis farted.
He just farted into the microphone.
Zoo animal.
And I think that's Kelly's microphone too, isn't it?
It's my mic cover though.
That's the best smelling thing that's gone into that mic.
Is it one moment or like a theme throughout the year?
Well, you know what? If anyone makes out with that microphone, they totally won't get a cold.
That's true. You're more likely to get a cold in your asshole from my tongue being in it.
My asshole is hot.
Dr. Louis J. Gomez.
Dr. Gomez.
All right. Thorn. Sammy.
Thorn from this year.
Now I gotta know. Talk about the elephant in the room. We all know what your thorn is. Jesus.
Just drinking?
Blonde? Yes. That's exactly what it was. Yeah.
Being a joke.
I would have to go. Yeah. Right? We're all thinking.
Was that this year?
That was huge.
But that's like a rose in its own right, though. How much steam did you get from that?
Yeah, but it cost me gigs on the road.
I think you got more out of it than you
from
lost.
I got support from comics.
But he got targeted by.
It cost me.
He sort of took the bullet for everybody, and I stuck up for him. But he was the one who was the target.
Yeah, it's. I think I don't even think.
You want to know how hypocritical it is? I retweeted a Bonnie McFarlane joke the other day where she said, "I caught my little kid."
I saw this.
Yeah, I caught my little kid posting vines. Don't worry, I've beaten her, right? And I thought it was hilarious. But you never hear anyone come up in arms like, "Whoa, this fucking child abuse, supporting child abuse culture." Child abuse happens all the time. Is it any worse?
I think a lot of it's just
a joke.
I think a lot of it's beyond the joke zone. Like, I think this lady just didn't like me. I think she saw this shit.
No, that's her career. So she looks for stuff like that to justify her existence.
Right.
Anyway, that's not your thorn?
Maybe, yeah. I mean,
you had a lot of bad shit happen. Your girl broke up with you.
Well, that was...
Yeah. That was all this year?
That wasn't this year. That was last year. Joe, I carried it into this year.
Joe, what's your thorn?
What are you talking about? Going in order. Huh.
Okay. Yeah, professionally, that was
Soder's so loyal now, he may be like, my thorn, Jesse May.
Yeah. Giannis being heartbroken. I care that much.
Yeah, comedy-wise, maybe.
I'm still stuck up on Joe getting herpes.
But I'm fine with it.
Mad at God for that.
Yeah. I'm good with it.
Either you fight with me and we win, or you fight with someone else and I win.
I had a great one.
No thorn.
Sorry, guys. Things are going really great.
Things are going pretty good.
I lost my keys.
Yeah. I had a $5 in my pocket, and I went to grab it. It was not the... my thorn was the cab driver took the lower level instead of the upper level. That's true, Bruce. And it upset me. And then Seamless was closed. This is going to sound... you guys are going to make fun of me, Bruce, but...
me moving to Miami? I'm sorry I left you, man. I apologize.
Nate moving to L.A. Because I think I'm out of writing spot. Not getting the Daily Show.
Oh, wow.
I was real hyped up.
You're
about
not getting
that.
More success.
Wait,
that
what were you
doing
on the Daily Show? Put myself in there, you know, they applied to be a correspondent and give me an audition.
Wow.
That hurt. I got real hyped up about
it. That's the worst thing that's happened to you all year?
I had the greatest year of my life. I can't complain.
Nothing else?
Wow.
I mean, I quit drinking. I got rid of that.
That's good. That's all
good.
Yeah,
that's a good thing. Quitting drinking in March was like the greatest thing ever.
Have you guys noticed that he looks about 5 years younger?
Nope.
No.
Thank you guys.
That's because you see him every day, but you do look
younger.
Yeah,
but before he looked like 10 years older.
I did. Everyone was like, I'd be like, I'm 29 to like,
no way.
I'm 37.
Yeah. Yo, drinking ages you crazy.
Yeah.
It really does age you.
But I really think quitting drinking helped the rest of my year go great because I was getting into a new place.
You got your shit together.
Yeah,
I would. That's not really a level three.
It was. It was, dude. That was pretty heartbreaking. Well, they got ramped up.
All right, fine. My thorn is not getting $1 million.
Yeah,
but that's not.
You know, it really sucked. That's my thorn.
I mean, you don't have anything else that happened.
It's got to be a thing that actually happened, not something that didn't happen to you. That's weird. So is it a good year? The new girlfriend.
Yeah, I got a great new girlfriend.
So hot.
I've been in. Okay.
That is so inappropriate.
What? I'm fine with it.
To say about
she's
his girlfriend, you want to
she's fucking
eat
she's
her ass. Yeah, but that's fucking.
You could have just said she's hot.
Don't you watch Guy Code? That's inappropriate.
I need to go to
Don't
Guy Code.
Don't ever talk about thy partner's girlfriend in front of thy partner.
No, you know what I love about you, Giannis?
It would be disgusting.
I'm going to take you to Judge Donnell's Guy Court.
That's fucking wrong, dude.
You know
because
the code.
If I said it behind Dan's back, then it would be a problem. Yeah, but I'm complimenting Dan.
No, they're both wrong.
Dan,
you did not
Dan,
compliment.
That's a compliment. I want to eat your girl's ass meat. Thank you. You're welcome.
Yeah, can I say that? You will not, but thank you.
Okay, I was not expecting it. Are you sure?
Oh, so we're not, we're just, it's not rude at all? It's a compliment?
No, it's a compliment.
Not right. Coming from Lewis?
Okay, so go up
a
to...
A speaking ape? That's not a...
Lewis, the animal steal!
Amy, want to eat your girlfriend's butt? Amy,
ass
hungry.
Amy. Is there no hand symbol for ass meat?
Amy, ass meat.
First time I saw Beatrice. I really wanted to fuck her in the asshole.
I believe it.
You didn't feel it. You didn't feel a little bit.
What are we doing? Dude,
you didn't feel a little disrespect
one time
there?
We were at Eastville when Beatrice was working there, and this is before before people knew I was dating her.
I didn't know she was dating her. So I was like, who the hell was that? And they were like, Lewis's girlfriend. I was like, what? No, that's not possible.
No, dude. I'll be talking about you. I'm talking about DeRosa one time. DeRosa was sitting there.
Oh, you gotta keep him away.
He was talking to me. He's like, oh, she's really hot. I was like, yeah, she's hot, right, dude? And he's like, yeah, God. I was like, what would you do? And he was like, oh, I mean, you have no idea. I was like, it's my girlfriend, bro.
That's a good one.
That's great.
I like how that he fucking Joe DeRosa just gets in there and just kind of washes over there slowly.
Fearless.
His fucking weird alien macking me hands.
Next thing you know, he's just somehow getting a stern cock sucking on a couch somewhere.
Yeah. Dude, Big J had the best line about DeRosa ever. He said he looks like fucking Garfield. What's his name? Dave.
John.
John from Garfield.
John Arbuckle.
That's
the best thing ever.
So, Liz, what's your thorn, man?
It's tough. The whole time I haven't been listening to anybody because I've been trying to think of my own.
Yeah, that's what I was.
Yeah, herpes was 211.
Nobody
right?
gives a shit about Sam Thorn because we were all trying to think of our own.
Yeah.
So like the person who went first is the only person that gets like a real thorn.
I'm still hung up that Soder has no thorns.
I mean,
I got.
I have small shit, but
can
I'm
I,
not gonna.
Can I guess for list thorn? Can
yeah,
I guess?
Yeah, you can guess.
Okay, I think not getting Letterman yet. Is that a thorn?
Well, he just said that we couldn't do
yeah,
that.
I mean, that's not
yeah, you can. Those are not thorns, though. No,
but
because
how?
We because we okay, always I, don't get shit.
You're pricked. You're yeah. not pricked by that, dude.
Yeah,
you. I always, was pricked by that. You don't know how I felt. That was upsetting.
Yeah, but it's not a thorn. That's like
that is a thorn. I disagree with you because that fucking hurts.
Ask the people in the chat room. Is that a thorn?
List,
not getting
not...
more success.
It seems thorny to me.
It's thorny.
That's your thorn.
All right.
Thorn.
Well, then it opens it up. Like Lewis is right. It opens it up.
No, it doesn't. Because you can't just be like, I can't get $1 million with someone. Like I'm going to give you $1 million.
No. So my thorn.
If Kelly was here and she was like that $4,000 gig that someone pranked me with, that was a thorn, and I agree with her. Because
no, that can't be a thorn because it was too funny.
Yeah. Yeah. That was the funniest thing that's ever been involved with Kelly.
Yeah.
But Lewis is taking it to a completely different place where it's like, oh, I didn't get $1 million. No, but you weren't offered $1 million or the possibility
hey,
of $1 million.
Stop taking easy on his career. Take
my thorn
easy.
Was Lewis staying in New York, I think. No, I think the last couple of days I had a like horrible anxiety. I had panic attacks
headache,
again, and
headache.
I had
See,
some
I listen
crazy
to you, buddy.
Sharp shooting yeah. pain the last 3 days. And I keep thinking that I've defeated anxiety, and then it comes back right. again. It's tough.
Yeah. That's I think that's a good one for
that's
you.
A good thorn. Yeah. yeah. So I keep feeling like I'm doing everything right, but it's still there. I have a crippling.
Why don't you try to just embrace the anxiety and just accept that's who you are and that
because it's a sharp shooting pain. It manifests as a sharp
no,
shooting pain
in my brain.
No, but
I think it's because you're trying to fight it. I mean, you're just a neurotic person.
No, that's what I'm saying. That's the problem. Is I'm doing everything right. I'm meditating, I'm writing, I'm sober. I'm doing yoga. I'm telling people how much I care about them.
Maybe you're neurotically trying to do too much because you're anxious to try to avoid all
Perhaps.
The anxiousness.
I'm mentally ill.
Soder wants to say something so bad.
I'm
right
so
now.
Ramped up because I agree with Joe. Ahead. And I don't like I threw mine out. I was like, oh, I don't get $1 million.
Yours is fine.
I'm not shitting on yours.
People are Corporate Dan is the wrong nickname.
Fucking my suicidal
he's,
thoughts before I quit
he's
drinking.
He's
how about
hard
that?
Line Dan. When he gets ramped up about something, there
That's
is no... Yes, it's a thorn. If it's anxiety, my suicidal thoughts can be a one.
All right,
that's
all
a thorn.
Had, we
that's
all,
a thorn.
All right, they're fine. Fine. I've had thorns this morning. Who cares, dude?
It'd be funny if this just revealed how awfully depressed Lewis was. He's like, yeah, like we don't think about it every 15
Who
minutes.
Does it, are you kidding? Who doesn't think about suicide?
I got to get this out. Here's my thorn. I fucked Beatrice, and I want you to know it.
This is a great window into Lewis's personality. This is a window into Lewis. You go like this. Hey, I got a fun game. Within 4 seconds of him learning of the existence of a game, he's like, "That's against the rules." That's not how it works.
Lewis, the animal steal.
4 minutes ago, he had never heard of this in his life.
I'll explain. I want more definition on why the Daily Show thing hurt. Was because I was like, oh, it's because my manager was like, eh, you know, straight white guy, you don't really have any flair, they're not looking for that. And then I get on the phone with Nate, and Nate's like, yeah, they offered me an audition for The Daily Show, but I said no. And I'm
why
like,
are you making oh, George W. Bush?
He's all, ah, we will find terror, and we will eliminate it. But that was like, oh, fuck, yeah. You're like, it was because I'm not good enough.
Well, let's talk about Nate's rose for a second. There's no thorns on that rose. Just a beautiful fucking rose.
His is that he's not rich yet.
Yeah. He's like,
I don't get the respect I deserve yeah. yet.
All right, let's get to Lewis's thorn before he kills somebody.
But Joe, I think it's a good thorn.
Oh, thanks, buddy.
And I think
yeah.
you're fighting through it.
I'm doing my best.
We're such assholes. Aren't
here,
we just
Joe.
Such assholes? We're like judging each other's fucking hardships.
You
like,
just
that's
moved up
to
number
hardship.
One friend, buddy.
What?
Ousted.
Fuck you, dude.
Later, Soder.
I'll fight him. I will fight him in his gorgeous torso.
Thank you.
His fucking Michael Phelps torso.
He does have a swimmer body, kind of.
Yeah. Lewis, what year did you get that tattoo? I might try to guess your thorn.
My thorn.
You better have a good answer after you just took him apart for his thorn.
No, I mean, I really should have thought of
that. That's not a thorn! Who's that a fucking thorn?
I was trying to be engaged with your thorn.
I'm Louis J. Gomez. I'm fucking civilized.
I'm not monster. I'm man.
It's a fucking compliment. I want to lick her ass meat. I'm giving a guy a compliment.
Which is a compliment.
Yeah, that is a compliment.
She's super hot.
That is offensive.
Why are you?
I like PC Giannis is my favorite.
That's
character.
Not even PC Giannis. Is that like?
That's for Palo Cristo.
Come on, if I like went up to you and like the girl that you loved, that girl who fucking broke your heart. If I went, yeah, dude, hey, I would lick her
he
ass.
He always brings her up. He always. Do you notice it?
He wants to hurt you.
Could do he's it a, back he's to him. A provocateur.
I'm a provocateur.
You're a provocateur, Giannis.
Sam, you could do it right back to him.
Yeah. I mean, bring my wound's a little fresher.
Yeah.
The
yeah.
stitches. You can still see the stitches.
I don't do it.
I think at this point.
Firsthand seen the pain, and that's why I stopped bringing it up. Giannis, you saw my pain firsthand.
I did, yeah.
You
I
did.
Saw it in a few nights drinking. You really got it in.
Guys.
Yeah. Yeah.
Guys.
Late at night? Yeah. It was not pleasant.
Yeah.
Guys, this is turning into Lewis's thorn. What's your thorn?
I think my thorn is the fact that I put on all this weight again.
Yeah. Oh, that's just a good thorn. Good
that
thorn.
Is a good
that
it's
is
a gross, gross thorn.
Yeah, oh. Can I change?
It's a big thorn.
Yeah. That's the least sharp thorn on earth.
Yeah.
Can I change my thorn to Lewis gaining all that weight?
His retired bouncer body is upsetting. Yeah, dude. You know, I fucking we had the baby, and it was so hard to like, you know, manage time, and it was a lot of other things. Like I've been so busy with my career as well that it just hasn't been. Turn I think when I first got in shape,
that's not a thorn. Your career's not a thorn.
No, my career's not a thorn. Me getting a me being fat.
No, his
is a
career
thorn.
Is a thorn right now. Yeah.
More of a seed that ain't growing.
Just buried it, just dropped into cement.
I think that's a good thorn. Thorn, you're fat and it's a thorn.
But I'm coming back. First of all, I'm not having any carbs except for this beer for the next 26 days before I go on this cruise.
No
going on a cruise, baby.
No
you're
brains,
working.
Dead.
Dead.
You're working cruise ships now?
I am working a cruise ship.
Scopo, do you want to play?
Don't forget to bring your visor or your hat.
Scopo, yeah. Scopo, what's
come on,
your thorn?
I got 25 minutes. You know that hat's coming off.
I don't know. I guess I fucking fight depression like you, Joe.
Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
I said
anxiety. Emotions as your thorn.
Yeah,
go fuck
yourself. Why not? I think that's fair.
I fucking
as long as
it.
You can become more I think you got to be a little more specific, though, if you do the emotion.
Lewis really
he thinks
does.
About his career, and then he's like, oh.
Yeah, exactly. Pretty much Giannis got it on the devil on the fucking thing right there.
Lewis,
yes. Yeah.
Lewis has 1950s style of parenting.
How
what are you, sad? Get rid of it.
What's up?
How long have you been doing comedy?
A little over 3 years.
Oh.
Feels like
that's not a good thorn.
Scopo, you're doing well.
Impressed about your fun. Career? Hold on, I didn't start making a living.
Yeah, dude, three years. Enjoy this fucking part of it. This is the only part. This is where there's no pressure at all. Just fucking enjoy the ride now.
Yeah, but you know what it is? I hang out.
Learn it from someone who's still there. Hop on board with me, buddy.
Yeah, this train's a long train. You can't move up cabins. I talk to everyone. You got to go stowaway the whole trip.
God, I feel like this show is Taekwondo for your feelings.
It really is.
Just like you come out of a black belt of not being able to feel anything.
Nothing.
It's like, come on, give me your best shot. Don't feel it. Don't.
You mean Kaekwondo.
Joe's on fire. Joe's on fire. Joe's on fire.
Oh, stop, guys. That's too nice.
So, Scopo, what is it? It's your depression?
You probably, because, you know, I hang out with a lot of older comics. Guys like you, old, making
that's
a living.
That's horrible.
No, but you're making a living at this. So, it's like, oh, I see all you guys making a living. It's like, oh, I fucking stop. I'll have to go home to my parents' house.
No, we started 10 years earlier.
No. Yeah, but it still sucks seeing it.
Giannis is because like he started at the Catch in Manhattan with Seinfeld.
You know it's never good when you get a text from your manager / comedy club owner who goes, you want to tell me what happened? I got hammered last night.
What happened?
Oh. Anyway, I'll do my
what'd
thorn, then we'll talk about
wait,
that.
Wait, how is that? What happened with that what? Chick the other night, by the way?
Which one?
The smoking hot one that came over to you.
Oh, yeah.
We still have roses and seeds to get to.
What happened with that?
Well, you know, we're working on it. We're planting some seeds. Oh,
she was smoking hot.
Yeah. Was she?
Oh, my
is she
God.
A fan of Marisa?
Yeah.
Oh, she is?
Yeah.
Dude, I've always
said
this.
You know what she looks like?
Yeah. You, it was, when you used to do the shows at the Times Square Art Center. Yeah. And,
the pussy I passed up, dude.
Oh, my God. And I was the white guy plant.
Yeah.
You remember? Oh, my God. There was like one show where it's just Latin girl after Latin girl was like, I love you, Giannis. And you're like, all right, baby. Can we get a picture? She's like, ooh, you sexy. And I'm just sitting there fucking pounding Coronas, watching you like, ugh.
Yeah.
And then they're like, that's the white dude. They called you on stage. I'm like, I'm a legitimate comedian. Yeah.
Wait, you planted Dan in your show?
Yeah.
Oh, he was great.
What happened though? Like,
it was paid like me $200.
Yeah, it was like,
it's awesome. Yeah. Before I was corporate Dan.
You had to go on stage and just, he had to
I had to
you?
Stand. This was great. This is one of my favorite stories. He used, so I had to stand in the audience where it was like look like she could spot me. Yep. Like I might have walked into the room to watch
which
the
is
show.
Like I like how you said she could spot me.
She's another character. It's Gaither. Yeah. So I had to look where Giannis could see me, and then you'd be like, oh, I'm looking for a white boy.
Who are you? Who's this right here?
And I'd be like, oh, I'm just here to watch the show.
And, would just...
and then I'd be like, I'm from Rye, New York. And everyone would be like, that's Westchester!
And I'd be like, yeah, where you from? And then they would just go, see, he would go, I'm Rye, New York, and they'd go crazy.
It was crazy. Watching him walk in as Mauricio, the first like weekend he did shows, was like watching fucking Hulk Hogan walk to the ring in 86. People were grabbing at her. It's fucking nuts. So this is my favorite story. So there's this show one late night, and I'm pretty hammered because, you know, I'm not doing comedy. I'm a fucking plant, and it's a Saturday night. Yeah. I have no sets. So I'm waiting for.
But I remember Jesse had to give you a talk because you were like upset about that. He was like, "Look, man, you're a good actor. Just do it for 5 seconds."
Jesse's like, "Yeah," and Jesse, who's Giannis's, you know, not the ex-girlfriend, but his partner, was like,
nice. "Giannis only associates with people named Jesse."
I was doing just shot after shot, like, dude, I should be doing spots. Why am I not doing spots? And Jesse's like, "Hey, you're making some money. You're having fun. We're being funny." And I'm like, it was driving me nuts.
Yeah.
So it's the last show I'm doing, and I'm like waiting for Giannis to spot me. And this, like, this dude in a wheelchair that's clearly an ex-gangbanger.
Oh, yeah, that guy. I remember that.
This guy fucking goes right in front of me where I'm standing. And I have to stand specifically to get to the stairs to go up on that huge stage at Times Square. So I'm sitting there waiting, and fucking Mickey from Boys in the Hood won't get out of my way. And he's just sitting there, and Giannis is like, who are you? And the thug's like, me, man, I fucking love you. And I'm like, no, man, he's talking to me. And he's like, nah, man, fuck you. Fuck you, white boy. He's talking to me. Yo, what's up, Marissa? I love you. And I'm like, no, man, I gotta get by. I gotta get to the stage. He's like, yo, man, fuck you, white boy. And I'm like, ah, oh, god damn it. And then I had to sneak by him and get on stage. And I remember being beat red and fucking furious on stage. Because I just wanted to shit on this guy, but I had no powers. I was a plant.
But the girls, I appreciate it. You were great at it.
But the girls that used to walk up to him after the show, I was like, they look like fucking Lowrider magazine chicks.
Yeah. So wait, hold on. Was this whole thing Giannis's thorn?
No, not yet. It was a sidetrack.
You know who was great at that, by the way?
Graham K.
It was
unbelievable. He had the big glasses.
Yeah, dude, that look on his face. You know that he goes,
oh, he's fucking awesome.
Wait, you just sat there by yourself, and everyone's latting around you? There. Everyone's latting around you except the one white guy?
Yeah.
And my thorn is easy, guys. Yeah. Come on. My thorn is my breakup. Yeah. The breakup of my family, my dogs, the whole thing.
Yeah.
No problem. But, you know, it's going to grow into a rose, so...
I don't know. That's not how that works.
No. Thorns, seeds grow. Yeah. Roses.
Thorns are just there to suck.
Yeah.
This isn't as bright as he claims to be.
Sammy, what's your rose petal?
Hey, really? Oh, skipped over Giannis.
You said it dismissively.
He had the biggest thorn.
I know, but we got to pick up the time. You're like, this is easy.
Girl, we've
talked about it enough.
I think he's kind of right. Yeah.
Have we not talked about Jesse May enough? Everyone gets it. You're Jesus right. Christ.
Everyone gets it.
You've handed it like a fucking champ, though, man.
I disagree, but keep going.
You know, he quit comedy.
Quit comedy? I got what they call a television job.
Yeah.
Even if it is called Wepa in the morning.
Wepa in the morning.
That's the best part. Highlight of the year.
It's hard to pick an individual thing. Just hanging with my friends.
You
know? Oh my god.
All right, fine. An individual thing.
Just me and Joe Mack sitting at a diner. You know, sharing a Corona. That's my highlight.
You know what?
We can get
our own beers. You
know? Something good must
what's
happen.
The best thing that happened this year?
Just steady sailing in New York.
Getting into the cellar.
That was actually last April, okay. not this April.
Still being booked at the cellar? You want to go with that one?
No. How about
having parents just look at Lewis?
That's a big rose.
That's a big rose.
Coming from someone that's also lost.
You didn't feel anything? Nothing?
But what about like
the point of the game is to get closer together.
I want to put my face in Beatrice's beautiful pussy and lick it down.
Guys.
It's a compliment.
It is. It is. Yeah. Absolutely.
I'd love to take her from behind, wrap my hand in her hair.
We're working on roses over here. Trying to make it real thorny.
I just love that he thinks that's a compliment.
I'm trying to think.
Montreal was a ton of fun. I don't know.
Oh, okay. Yeah, Montreal. You got new faces.
You got new faces.
Yeah, yeah. That was. Yeah, but yeah. It's not the actual new faces. It was the actual week of just getting hammered and having fun.
But you got it.
But you went to Montreal.
Yeah.
That's huge.
That was a good one.
You don't know comedy. That's a big deal.
It's a big deal.
Lewis will be there in 5 years.
Yeah, big deal.
No, I won't. Let's get real.
Yeah. Montreal's a big deal. I got absolutely zero out of it.
Yeah. Nobody really gets anything out of it, but it is sort of a rite of passage.
That's not true. Dan Soder.
It's like a stamp saying, like, here's a crop of the new funny guy. You know, it's like a stamp. It's like a stamp you get, right?
Yeah.
People get stuff out of it. Sam got an agent. Soder got a career.
I did.
Yeah, you did. You fucking murdered it.
Thank you.
Murdered it.
Danny boy?
My rose, meet my girlfriend.
Oh, that's really sweet.
I knew it from really the start. Sweet. You would break my heart.
Wait, what?
But still, I had
it's really
to play.
Sweet. Yeah, it's gonna end so badly.
Oh my God, guys!
It's a pretty
finger. Guys, with your magic it was a good smile. Thing.
She's an actress, right?
Yeah. Yeah, it's gonna I don't like his laugh, and I don't like the way he said it.
You guys let's do Thorns for 2014.
Let's go back. Yeah, my drinking problem reemerging after the breakup.
Dan, you're never going to believe this. I got it's me and Matthew McConaughey. It's a four-hour love flick.
Do you know who's such a good kisser on set? Dylan McDermott.
Or the other option is Phil Hartman's story. Remember that?
Oh, no. What was that? Oh, yeah, his wife
killed him and killed his kids. No, he killed
the... She quit her acting career. She couldn't deal with the fact that
he was
she didn't
famous
realize her dreams.
I think what happened was he had an affair as a reporter and she murdered him and then her.
Yeah, and she also was on a lot of booze and drugs. Yeah.
You know that story about her earrings swinging in the beginning of the show? When they go through, it's Phil Hartman! And they show everyone, he's at like a diner, and there's a woman with her head back. And her earring is swinging, but the director had to yell at her to turn her head, because she was facing the camera the whole time. She was like a
true
psycho.
Story?
Yeah.
I know.
And they were like, you need to turn around, and she was pissed.
I didn't hear anything about affair. I think it was more had to do with that.
It was jealousy. Yeah. She was a jealous lunatic.
And I'll murder her.
Now, let me ask you a question.
What's going to happen is she's going to get a role in a 3-hour romance with Matthew McConaughey. It's going to be like a love story where she has to fuck Joaquin Phoenix and Matthew McConaughey on screen.
It's going
to
be called Ask Me. What?
Because I went through it.
Your girlfriend made out with Matthew McConaughey.
No, it's like that. If somebody gets some success, it changes the dynamic of the relationship.
I'm very supportive. So I don't. If it does happen, I told her if I break my heart, I'll just end up becoming one of the greatest kind of comedians of all time.
There you go. Win-win. Yeah. I like that, too.
So it's just...
Well, I hope you guys stay together forever.
Okay.
No, I think it's a win-win. And I think if that does happen, then you have your answer. It's almost like you're lucky. You're like, oh, this is the type of check she is.
If I get to stay with her, if she stays with me, because that's really what it is. If she stays with me...
You're in. You're sold.
I'm fucking lucky.
Dan, you gotta fucking... What are you talking about, dude? It's not that horse shit. Keep it fucking sexy.
She loves you, dude. Real ass dude.
Okay, you, she's not going like I'm fucking giving this guy.
No, I know she's not doing that.
Welcome to Love Jones with real ass dude. But I'm Jay Gomez.
But I'm saying,
you walked at the party yesterday. The one chick was like, "Who's that?"
Which party?
My son's birthday party that all my good friends were invited to. The one girl was like, "Oh, who's that? He's got a girlfriend." I was like, "Oh yeah." And then I said, "She's pretty hot. I want you to wrestle me." And then B got mad. But true story.
Yeah, you got that good combination of like handsome, but also look like you lift wood. So you're like a combination.
He looks like a country guy.
You look like a blue collar fantasy. Beef also, cake. You're successful. You know
guys,
what I mean?
I think this is my rose.
Yeah,
you're bringing up my beautiful girlfriend.
Soda. Yeah,
my beautiful, funny, smart, nice.
You got a face like you know how to lift wood or like, throw a line into the water and catch a fish.
What do you need? You need me to mainline something?
Yeah, you have that. You look like you've accomplished stuff in the wilderness.
I can clean out your garage.
What are you doing, Scopo, besides slowing down the flow?
He's being a nice host, Giannis.
I think Giannis has actually turned into Bobby pretty well. Good job, actually.
Yeah, what are you doing, dude?
No, there's not that threat of imminent danger in his voice when asking Scopo.
If Giannis gained 8 pounds, he'd actually look like Bobby.
Give him the fucking wig. That wasn't that good.
That was pretty good.
I'm looking pretty sexy and svelte. So put that on your little fucking 1930s bartender hair.
Put it right here.
Joe List, what's your rose?
Oh, boy. Just so many roses. You know what I mean? Everything came up roses.
By the way, congratulations on your year of
sobriety. Oh, thank you. Seriously.
Right. Dude, I could not be prouder of both you guys, man.
Oh, thanks.
More fucking unbelievable.
I am prouder.
More proud.
More proud.
Yeah. I am proud.
Really? Is that what we're going to do?
I think you should be proud of List. I'm proud of List because he's sober. Yeah, I am a pothead, so.
I'm proud of you because you're sober.
Yeah, but you quit drinking,
Yeah, you are
man.
Soder.
That's, That's a big thing. And you quit cigarettes, but the drinking was big because you were gonna die. That's you would die. There's no way you wouldn't die from drinking.
No way.
No way. I remember walking into the bathroom at cabin. That sounds like this.
Oh, when I was puking?
When you just, you just puked, and then when, like, you were puking.
Puking rally.
Yeah, I was peeing, and then you came in and just puked behind me into the bowl, and then you went out and just continued drinking your beer. Yeah, I was like, that's when somebody just has a problem, yeah.
I was pretty good at drinking. Yeah. But Joe, what's your rose?
You guys are great at it. He's
Joe,
a good one.
What I'm is a fun one, your dude. Fucking Santa. Rose, ADD Giannis?
Sorry.
Let him say his rose.
Sorry, Lewis.
Have you ever really drank with Sam?
Yeah,
that's
he
not
likes
that
to call.
Enjoyable.
He gets confrontational around drink nine.
Yeah, that's what I'm being.
Oh, Sam's the best.
I confronted you?
Yeah, let me tell you, Sam.
No, about other people.
Sam is the best opening drunk game for Asian girls ever. Like, he nails it.
Oh, boy.
He's it's what's up, cunt?
No. He walks up and goes, ho-to-to-to-to-to. No, dude. It's such a cheesy line, but he goes up to this girl. He's like, hey, what's going on? And she's like, I don't know. He's like, come on, hey, yeah, you. And she's like, I don't know. He's like, I'm just kidding, I don't know you. And then she laughs, and they sit down, and they talk. But a minute later, Sam's got his hand on her tit. I'm like, Sam, stop touching her. What are you doing, dude?
It's good.
And plus, you love Asians.
I'm weaning off, dude. Okay. I'm getting sick of them. You know? All right. I'm that's one of my rooms for improvement for 2014 is to accept people for who they are.
And not fetishize them.
Yeah. I'm being a better person, Jan. Yeah. I went through a hard period that stemmed out of it stemmed out of me going for, like, I need the exact opposite, and I'm weaning off. I'm good now.
Do you guys think I was a Greek fetish for Jessie Mae, the John Stamos thing, you know?
There's no such thing as a Greek fetish.
She had another Greek boyfriend.
Did she really?
Me. Yeah.
Pete Davidson's Greek? Oh, there, boy. He was just pounding her out. It's not really.
You're an animal. You have no civility.
You know what I like?
You don't deserve the J in your name. That's why I don't want to call it. From now on, I'm going to, out of spite, I'm going to say, coming to the stage, Luis fucking Gomez.
Yeah, because J is a J. Gentleman. Yeah. That's a gentleman J.
Gentleman J.
That's how Giannis spells gentleman with a J.
I loved it.
What's your rose?
I guess sobriety in the cellar. I don't know. They both have working here instead of working here. That was
helpful. That was great.
That was big news.
I've never seen so many people excited to see someone get passed as Joe List.
Oh, thanks.
There really was just a buzz in the olive tree where it's like, he's in.
He fucking deserves it, man.
Yeah.
Thanks. Yeah.
If good comics aren't working
a club, the club should be embarrassed.
Joe List is one of my favorite comedians out there.
Oh, thanks, everybody.
Can always watch his set.
Oh, a lot of fans. I got a lot of fans this year from this podcast.
Yeah.
And you know who you are, lady.
Lewis, what's your rose?
I mean, there's two.
No, that was last year.
I mean, I guess it would be one of two things. This podcast has been a really big rose for me.
Yeah.
It really has. It's like
I could never imagine this podcast without you on it.
Thanks,
you're
buddy.
Fucking so good on this.
Someone, Tyler Norcal, tweeted out. He said, 2011 MVP Dan Soder, 2012 MVP Joe List, 2013 MVP Lewis J. Gomez.
Yeah.
Boom. I actually demand a recount.
Yeah.
I think
I demand a renig.
Now, his voice on the I don't mean like literally the voice. I mean your comedic voice just works very.
You know what he is? He's the head henchman. You need a good bad guy.
Yeah.
He's a good bad guy. You know the bad guy that you got to beat.
And he loves being the bad guy.
He's a good bad comic.
He loves being the bad guy.
No, I think Lewis is getting really funny.
Thanks, man.
I think that should be part of the roast.
You know, you've been saying that to me for 3 years.
It's getting there. We're getting there.
Mine was a zing, but then you had to say getting, which implies that you think that he's not
backhanded
funny.
Dickhead compliment.
No, it's not. I mean, getting really funny. I didn't say getting funny. I said getting really funny.
Yeah, it was.
Right?
Look, the podcast.
When you see someone who you really, you fucking hate me, Joe.
You said
I know
getting
you fucking,
funny.
I said
can I
getting
my
really
rose,
funny.
Giannis.
Don't just try to change what happened to make your point, Joe.
Kiss by a rose.
There was a many time in the sun.
Giannis is a German. He's a big jerk.
My power, my pleasure, my pain. You know, that's about cocaine.
Is it about cocaine?
Yeah. Scopo, your rose.
I wasn't done with my rose.
He's not done with his rose.
We got it. The podcast.
It wasn't just the podcast.
Giannis thinks you're decent now.
It was getting management. That was a really big deal. It was a lot. Staying in New York. It really all this stuff kind of like helped my confidence, which helped me get over a hump because I was very close to. I don't want to say quitting comedy, but
I was pretty close to, like, just really just, I mean.
Selling posters for Nate in L.A.
Mr. Bargatze can't sign that for me. It's $17.99. He's like, hey, Lewis, I ran out of ink on this Sharpie.
Sure, Mr. Bargatze, you're moving to L.A.? Sure, I'll come with you, yeah. Sure.
Oh, Mr. Bargatze, the world's going to be yours.
Sure I will, but our kids can play together,
yeah,
and everything.
Yeah, we'll be friends.
Sure we can.
Right, boss?
Can I get you a soda? A Diet Mountain Dew with some dip, Mr. Bargatze?
What do you want? You want me to tell you the score?
All right. Scopo, you're Rose.
It's got to be the show. This fucking show has done a lot
this
for me.
Is the biggest thing. I can't even, when I see you in this room, I'm like, he doesn't deserve this.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I mean, I agree.
Jesus. Hey, you don't just say stuff like that.
I got to call this episode Truth Serum.
God. This is fucking brutal.
I'm just kidding. You're very cool. Funny. I've never seen
you do comedy.
Scopo, I'm not
Giannis.
First time you take it right away.
First time I met Giannis.
I've never watched
one on one, and he was hosting. And I was like, what's your name? I was like, Chris Scopo. He does obviously 12 minutes in between.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Then he
do you do this?
Yeah, I can do time. Yeah.
Yeah. And then
he like, oh yeah, bleh, bleh.
I thought he worked at the bar. I thought he was cleaning drinks.
And he was like, what's your name? Funny guy, but what's your name? And I was like, oh, Chris Hobo. And he's like, this fucking guy coming to stage. Funny guy.
This couple really looks like a fucking bar back.
Yeah. That's that look. That's what I thought. They was coming to clean up.
I think
drinks.
Every time he walks in the room we should go, we're out of Budweiser.
You had a great set at LOL last night.
I wasn't there, but thanks.
Oh. That was Robbie Bernstein.
I knew something was coming on that one.
You guys are getting good.
Joe's on fire. Joe's on fire. Joe's on fire. Liz, Giannis, what's your rose?
Oh, man. My rose.
Is it your internet show? Your web series? Is it the new web series?
Is somebody mistaking you for Latino?
No, I would say,
not seeing your dogs anymore.
Oh, Jesus,
Lewis.
For the jugular.
No, that's the names of his dogs, Jesus and Lewis. His Latino dogs, the Marisa thing. Wepa, this is Luis.
I think that the rose is also my breakup, because through my breakup, I've strengthened friends.
By the way, he had this plan the whole time. Like, it's his rose and it's his thorn. It's fucking being all deep.
Can I just be honest here?
Let's be honest. Let's be honest. Yo, son, politics be like a nigga. What's up?
I'm not. I eat Greek yogurt. Baka. Wepa. I'm telling you, I got an ass pussy.
Politics be like a nigga.
Let's be honest.
Politics be like a nigga.
Yeah. That's my favorite
segment.
I've
never said that.
It's my favorite segment.
But it does encapsulate.
I think your rose was punching that woman in the face.
Oh, that felt good. But that was last year.
That was last year. Yeah.
That was right. I brought in the new year with that.
That was last year's seed.
That was right before the new year. Yeah. No, I really do believe that. It strengthened friendships. I feel like it's making me a better comic, better person. So it's really...
Plus, now you're getting all that Latino pussy.
What the say? Hashtag the say.
Hashtag knee deep and some Latin trim. Sam, what's your plan?
What are you looking for? What you planted something for next year?
Me and Joe Mackey, we started the walking podcast. I wish that was on the phone.
God damn it, Giannis. It's not a walking podcast anymore.
That was one of the... Joe said, what, your walking podcast didn't work out?
That was a portion where we took a walk, and actually it was good, but it's too cold. I can't do it in this weather.
It's very cold. I don't like the cold.
I get allergies in this weather.
Oh, my hands.
It's no fun.
My hands don't work as well.
It's no fun for anybody. I'd rather be
in Florida.
Honestly, a couple things I look forward to next year is just, you know, I start my own podcast. That's been fun.
I'm doing it tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
He wasn't invited to Reginald's birthday party today.
That's true. Reginald J.
I mean, so that's exciting. I'm excited about the podcast. I'm excited about just, you know, getting on the road again in January.
Right, this isn't an acceptance speech at the Creek in the Cave.
You just want a Creaky Award.
I'm feeling the buzz a little because I've been eating yet today.
Ooh.
That's what happened to me last night.
Yeah.
I know exactly where we're at. God. Me and Giannis went out last night.
No, but before, that's what Chris just said. He said, you want to tell me what happened?
First blood.
I was hosting and I couldn't stand. Like, I got so drunk. I was hanging out with this girl at the bar, and I just kept banging Bloody Marys with no food in me at all.
Ugh.
And I had like eight of them. And then I thought I could handle it. I got up and I couldn't stand. So I went up on stage, and like I couldn't speak. I was like holding the wall. I was seeing three. It was brutal. And then like so I could barely host. It was so bad. Christine was like, "You want me to call Derek? Can you just do this?"
Wow.
Let's switch to the
bullpen. Yeah. If you're fucking going to Derek Gaines, you know there's a problem.
I don't understand how you that fucked up and then at LA.
Because I didn't eat anything.
Disregard this fucking animal. Yeah.
Lewis really Lewis that
the
one.
Animal
that
steals.
Oh, you hear that, Derek Gaines? I'm coming for you. I'm coming for you. Sweating?
Yeah, he's fucking an animal. So, yeah, I hadn't eaten anything, so that's why I was.
It's a bad place to be. That's where I was 6 out of 7 nights. I get off my restaurant job, and I'd be like, yeah, I'll do a shot and a beer.
Yeah.
And the next thing you know, it's fucking 1:30, and I'm just one-eyeing everybody, and I'm like, who wants to go?
I mean, I had 3 more spots that night. I ate, and then I did the spots. I was better. Like, it was at 7 p.m.
He was fucking forgetting who he was. He was going into Marisa and Panos, like, left and right.
No, they said, like, all the
politics are...
I think it was Ari was on. Ari, DeMeo, Dante Nero, Rachel Feinstein, and they were all just fucking... gigging on me. Like that. Supposedly I tried it one joke. I tried to tell it 4 times. Just kept bringing it up.
No.
But I didn't finish it. I kept going like, so anyway, guys, like this is when you're going through a breakup.
Have you guys done that before? Have you ever repeated material on
one time?
Yeah. It's fucking hard.
It's so embarrassing. And there's that moment where I don't realize it. I've done it with a lot of short jokes. And I'll go into it. And I'm like, why? What, you guys don't like that one? They're like, no, you've already told it.
Dude, I've done the setup twice. And then I realize it in the middle of it. And you got to go like, you make up a different punchline altogether. On the spot.
I just remember this British lady. You've already told that one. When I was hammered at Stand Up New York. And I was like, yeah, I know. But I like it so much. I want to do it twice. And then I was like, I went to the bar. And I was like, shout out James. gotta forget about that one.
So wait, whose seed are we on now?
Me.
Man, what's your seed?
Dan, what's your seed, bro?
I think my seed that I planted
With my girlfriend. Things are going good.
I think things are just gonna
I
be
I saw a proposal this year.
Nah, not this year.
Yep.
Probably moving together. I think it was it's a
I
mixture.
Wouldn't do that. There's no reason to rush that.
I think it's a mixture of my not drinking and finally feeling like a headliner on the road. I think that's the seed. I'm excited to go out now because I can do, 60 without fucking sweating when you're bombing. I can do 60 while bombing, which is pretty good.
Yeah, feels normal.
No, it's not.
I'd like to thank San Antonio, Kansas City, and Marco Island for getting me over that fear.
Marco Island, that is a great place to feel
for,
the heat.
For Patrice O'Neill for opening for you in San Antonio.
Yeah, I want to thank the guy doing the Patrice O'Neill impression in San Antonio and burying me.
Well, there was a dude that was like doing Patrice.
He did he was doing his act, and I was like, "Hey, man, you're fucking doing Patrice." And he was like, "Oh no, man, I'm just inspired by him."
Yo, I'm inspired by him. Yeah.
Yo, I'm a vessel.
Yo,
what
he meant to say is like, "Yo, in the black rooms, nobody really cares about that." So.
Yeah,
yo,
they don't know that. Oh, you watched his HBO half hour special?
Yeah, black people have never written any jokes. They just have a book of jokes that they all use. No.
That's just a negative stereotype.
There you go, Morrell. So, yeah, not drinking and feeling like a headliner. I think that's a good seed. I'm excited to build a new joke in 2014.
Well, you're a monster. Everybody in the room is a monster.
Some of us more literally than others.
Lewis is the physical representation of being a
monster. Yeah, no, I live under a child's bed.
Lewis is such a good guy to have as a friend. You know,
speaking of monsters, there's his little fucking crew showing up.
My crew's showing up right now. Hammerfist is about to take over the YKWD podcast.
That ain't going to happen.
Now. Joe, what's your seat? Quick.
My seat is I'm working on a cure for herpes. I have a big thing of porridge that I'm just stirring at my house.
A big kettle?
Yeah. Joe's current cure for herpes is honey. You're okay with this, right?
Yeah.
What?
Never mind. All right.
What?
Joe, you're
give me that bandana.
You know how a lot of the guys in AA go and do performances at like AA meetings and stuff. Why don't you tap
performance?
Yeah, you know when you're just wearing your heart on your sleeve.
Hilarious. Yeah. Like Mo.
Why don't you?
Your eyebrows are a perfect match for that fucking wig. That's hilarious.
Why don't you tap into that, to the herpes, the herpes groups and stuff like that?
Yeah, I should get. Maybe I will.
Be a role model for that.
I don't think there's a lot of herpes dating.
Are there herpes groups?
There are like websites and stuff like that.
How do you know?
Support groups.
How do you know?
I don't know. Let's just say.
Oni.
Lewis. Miami in the house, 305, son.
Oh, stop it. I don't like your local fucking... Yo, you ever been down on that street where
yo,
I eat?
Biscayne, Northwest 13. Yo, yo, yo.
I really hate Giannis's local
LeBron
Miami.
LeBron James.
I love the Heat, even though I grew up in New York as a Knicks fan.
I'm a total Heat fan now.
You fucking suck.
I'm a Heat fan.
Fuck
that's
you.
Right.
You were in a Brooklyn Nets shirt.
You know what I think about Giannis?
Fuck yourself. Jesus Christ. Are you really a Heat fan?
I'm a Heat fan, yeah.
You're smell a piece
that
of
heat.
Shit,
I'm a Heat fan.
You're a piece of shit.
I'm a Heat fan.
You're fucking dead, man.
Because I'm a grown-up, and I've made that decision to root for a champion.
Why?
That's all.
You know what? You're
a fucking Heat fan. Because fuck the Knicks. The Knicks will never be anything with fucking Dolan. He's a spoiled rich kid.
But you don't go to the Heat. You don't go to the Heat.
You don't fucking seed. You're every Heat fan.
You don't go to the fucking Heat. Fuck you, dude.
Fucking
Heat. Do you leave?
Yeah.
Down by five, you leave the game, it's over.
Fuck the Knicks.
Why can't I get back into the arena? I want to watch the overtime.
What a bunch of shit fans.
I cheer for anybody
fuck
but
Miami
the Heat.
Fan.
Giannis called.
Why?
Giannis
you're
called.
A Miami
Why?
Heat fan.
And you're not. Oni, are you a Heat fan? There you go.
Giannis
called
you're a New Yorker.
Fucking
how
honest.
Dare you? If you want to leave the Knicks at five, but you don't go to Miami. You don't do it.
I can't talk to you with that on your head right now.
Okay.
What?
You don't go to Miami.
I live there.
Dick move.
I live there, Sam. But I live there.
Fuck
yeah, but
you're
honest.
Can't I just be an adult and root for the team and
no,
see how
no,
I live
no,
in?
You can.
Why
you
not?
You can't.
Giannis,
because there's a thing online that tells you if you want to leave the Knicks, how you have to go about it, and there's only a few teams you're allowed to go to. It's like
Brooklyn?
The Timberwolves. No, not Brooklyn. You can't do New York.
I haven't
Nuggets.
Been a Knicks fan in
you,
fucking
you
20
to,
years,
you
Sam.
You have to do the Timberwolves.
Yeah, Giannis hasn't been a fan
Thunder,
of them since they were called
the
Knickerbockers. Nuggets?
Nuggets are allowed. Okay. It has to
just
be Western Conference.
Forget jokes, everyone. Just forget the idea of jokes on this show. Let's start yelling about basketball, you fucking faggots.
Oh, yeah, you know what?
Yeah, Lewis the Animal Steel!
Oh, sorry, guys. We got to wrap up so Lewis can just yell about fighting.
Did you see the way that fucking leg broke in 16 fucking places?
I like Lewis.
It was shocking!
He's doing Lewis doing Dickie V. He's like, this is crazy, baby! That was a spinning heel kick!
Nobody!
Oh,
nobody fucking
it.
Saw that coming!
I love it!
Nobody fucking saw it coming!
All right, Lewis. What's your seed, Joe?
What's your seed, Joe?
My seed is fucking quitting this podcast after the last 4 minutes.
That's brutal.
That might have been the worst 8 minutes in the history of the fucking
podcast.
That was
Sam Morrell fueled
that was
loyalty.
Horrible.
I'm fucking psycho.
Sorry. You yeah. missed my Knickerbocker joke, and you guys all
it.
Failed.
I caught it.
Well, Giannis is the host. I blame him.
Well, you know.
And
he
fucking
should be telling me
traitor.
The Miami Heat fan on the air.
Now, that was bullshit.
Thing.
I'm with Sam on that one.
That's fucking bullshit. We could have told him that it was bullshit one person at a time.
If I knew that was true, I
got a little out of control.
That was true.
I care about the show. Everyone's just yelling at the same time. We just bled out all of our listeners. To the six people left, my seed is trying to have sex with you, whether you're a man or a woman. It is.
All right.
That wasn't bad. That was a trick with your hair. All right.
What's all right. your seed, Lou? Is it a bad joke like Joe's?
No. It's not. I think my seed, getting with my management. You know, we have a lot of cool things that we're working on right now. I like working with a production company because I have a lot of ideas. So I like being able to go to somebody and have somebody that knows the process of getting shit on television. So I feel like it's going to really set up a lot of good things for 2014.
I hope your TV ideas are better than your tattoo ideas.
They don't know who he is. They used to thought it was some dude.
This is Minnesota Dave. Russian cop came in.
Yeah. I work for Kremlin.
This Minnesota Dave. You were great in Eastern Promises, dude.
he produces the Hammer Fisting Show. I'm really sorry you lost in round two of Over the Top.
Oh, he's the producer of the show?
Yeah, well, he's intern producer.
He's big time, all right.
He's 54 years old. I don't like calling him an intern. It's weird, but...
Oh!
They're getting uglier as they come in.
Kelly Fastuca just walked into the building.
What are you doing?
I'm busy. I gotta watch some people.
We just said that. I can't believe it's true.
How did you know we said that?
You know what? I actually just signed with Kelly. I got high hopes.
The USS Minnow. Everyone knows the name of the ship on the map.
Kelly takes 75% of your soul. Oh, God.
What are you doing?
Kelly, except for me. Except for me. Oh, boy. Right?
Oh.
Right?
Wait, except you came me. All the way to do this, Kelly?
I didn't say nothing. Yeah, she's a nice person, contrary to what...
He doesn't fill him
up. We have to wrap up, so finish the fucking seeds.
Yeah.
Kelly, thank you. Scopo, even though you're sick.
He doesn't write
anything
on here?
Don't touch me, you're sick.
Why would Kelly, you write something? Dan did not mean what he said.
Not at all. It was a joke.
It was a joke. It was a joke.
You're not on a mic, and it's just the worst sounding podcast ever.
Yeah.
Just bye, Kelly.
Bye, Kelly.
Be safe in Australia.
Yeah. Huh?
He ate himself to death. He's fat.
Guy's trying to lose weight.
Guys, get it?
Yeah.
All right, Lewis, what's your seed?
I said
you just did it. You were texting, you jerk.
Scopo. Scopo.
What a dick move.
I could give two shots.
It wasn't even, it was like serious Lewis, too. It was like a weird.
Yeah, yeah.
We're working on a couple good projects that I really like. My management right now. It's a couple good projects.
I got my eye on a couple roles that I really think are going to test me.
It's really exciting to have somebody believe in you.
I love motivated Lewis, though. Put a smile on my face.
Lewis calls his manager dad.
His dad's dead.
That was the joke.
Yeah.
I picture giving a knock
to my manager
Ryan,
up in heaven.
To Ryan from
Listen
Comics.
It in.
How he weirdly calls his dad to everybody.
He's like, oh, do you guys want to do a single daddy?
Oh, he's fucking psycho. Creepy. So dad came and said, I was like, dude, he's not my dad.
Yeah.
You know my dad? He's back? I thought he died in 97. Oh my God. Gary!
So Scopa, what's your thing?
What's your seat,
what's your
seat
from Queens, Dan? Queens, what are you doing there, yeah. Scopa? What are you? I want to be a really good comic this year.
So yo, I got some new rims for my car.
You know, I want to get some things done here.
I'm looking to save up, get a new pair of jeans that don't get worn out from my cheeks. Rubbing against the denim.
Well, you guys pretty much said it. No, I don't know. Just fucking getting funny and I guess being on the show.
That's not a seed. It has to be something that happened this year.
I don't know. That's gonna maybe doing more road shows, maybe getting management. I don't know, Lewis. Stuff like that.
You don't understand the seed.
You're
is
not
what I'm
allowed
saying.
To get upset about people breaking your balls.
Yeah.
You're not allowed to get upset. That breaks.
No, I'm 12 times Alan. I don't realize I'm getting upset.
Yeah, you
it just
can't
comes out.
Get upset here. This is what we do here. We hurt feelings.
That's why. And by the way, you upset. Lose. When you get upset, you lose automatically.
By the way, I'd say Scoop. Scopa. What's his name again?
Scoop.
I think Poopoo.
Poop Scoop.
Chris Poop. Poop Scoop.
Hey, Poop Scoop.
Chris Poop, as far as like we were talking about, this is like jujitsu for your feelings.
Yeah.
He's a fucking white belt.
Well, here's the
he's
thing.
He's a fucking white belt. He cannot take Poops, anything.
Well, hold on. There is no
and
white belt in jujitsu. It's a blue belt program.
Well, whatever
you get
it is. Isn't he supposed to be the one fucking taking the most shit and just taking it and he's getting upset?
I've
by the way,
taking it a bunch of shit.
Oh, yeah. If you think that's good. The case, Kelly's going to hate me for the rest of her life because of what I said.
She just said she's going to have a great career in this business as a manager. And
that
he said
it's the best thing she's ever done, though.
Yeah, but.
Same in that Montreal line.
That was great.
It
was good. That was great. But you know what's going to be
That's
happening?
What you call a backhanded compliment. That was the greatest thing she's ever done in her life.
But I'll tell you this. I know Kelly. Oh, yes, please. She's going to tell Bobby, and then it's going to get weird. And the next time I come in for this podcast, she's not going to look at me or talk to me. And she's like,
oh, but Dan said I was going to be a manager.
Because I had a fucking hilarious joke.
Yeah. Well, no, it wasn't that funny when you said it. It was real serious.
It wasn't serious. Yeah, what you're doing right now is you're backpedaling on the joke.
Yeah, you're trying to play yourself as a fucking martyr here.
Because he cares about her feelings, dude.
No, he doesn't.
A good person.
That's not what's going on.
Yeah,
I actually do.
Yeah. And you know what? Kelly's getting funnier from what I hear, right?
What? Yeah. You fucking. You haven't heard her comedy, I mean.
Well, you posted a Vine video of her killing, and I heard
that
crowd roaring.
Yeah. Yeah. She does, actually, she does really well with
tourists.
She
does tourists. Well for
6 seconds. Kelly, date me for 2.5 years. I'll take you to the top.
Yeah. You want to rock it? Just fucking let Giannis put himself inside you. What's your seed?
My seed is.
Not in Jesse May.
It all comes full circle.
Fucking sniper ass dick. It's the show I'm doing down there in Florida. I feel like I'm really building something, and so hopefully it grows into something great.
What, a tolerance to waking up early?
Yeah. Huh?
305 Oni.
Oh, shut
literally,
up.
Literally the no, 305.
No, that's how much Oni weighs. 305.
Giannis is the only one contractually.
Oh. Take a sip of water and then put that wig over that dumb haircut.
Nope, it's a flat tire, not a bomb.
Oh, all right.
It's a little different.
Giannis is the only one contractually obligated to his seed.
Yeah. Giannis, you've been down south too long. List doesn't get wigs no more.
You haven't heard.
Yo, Giannis, you've been down doing TV for no one too long.
Nah. I wasn't insulting nobody. Nah. Give me a water list.
All right. I mean, I got a hammer fisting show starting, so.
Oh, okay. We don't care. And,
I'll do this goddamn podcast for another hour.
Yeah.
You just told me you couldn't be hammer fisting, which is an hour that's starting right now because you have a show.
I do. I have to go. I'm going to stand up New York at 7:15.
Welcome to Hammer Fisting. Did you see that leg breaking for a 10 places? The fucking big shatter!
Can you believe
that?
I mean, Josh Barnett getting that stoppage? I can't believe
it. I mean,
that
was fucking ridiculous.
I can't believe it.
Because I called it, motherfuckers.
Chris Weidman,
you did
not
call it. I should have put money on it because Gomez is pushing me to put money on it.
Travis Brown, the dark horse of the heavyweight division in the UFC.
Why are you standing up?
Because I can't shadowbox sitting down. The way he beat Alistair Overeem. It's unbelievable. MMA.
How long have we been going?
Hour and 38 minutes.
Oh, what are we supposed to do? Two? I think we're done.
I think we're done. Yeah, we're done. You're not bleeding over in hammer fisting time.
Oh, okay. I didn't know the hammer fisting.
Well, if we started on time, we'd be fine.
Yeah.
Why are you looking at me, Joe?
Joe's only speaking for one
guest
today,
host, by the way. I'm sorry.
Scopo ran out. I'm just sitting.
I'm mad at Scopo, but Scopo's we're not
producer.
Good enough friends for me to project at him, so I have to yell at you.
That's a good point.
And you're the co-host.
Yeah, but I mean, I'm the co-host on TV. If the production starts late, it's not my fault. No, I'm on set.
But
I got
a
TV show.
Production
stop TV. Throwing your fucking Miami bullshit lingo around here, your showbiz terms.
That's
Miami
not Miami
bullshit,
lingo.
Your
that's
favorite basketball
showbiz.
Team.
I'm on set.
I went now. I'm just saying.
I'm on set. That's what that means. I'm on
guys!
Set.
Guys! Wrap it up.
Let's wrap it up.
Poop scoop.
All right, guys.
Put yourself in there.
Bobby. Bobby wasn't watching this at all?
No, I did not get one text from Bobby.
He doesn't care about his own podcast?
You
should lost him.
Want to go get him?
Well,
he's the owner, technically.
And also, I tell you what. Part of my rose is this fucking show. I love this show.
Me too.
I love it. I think Bobby is just
been a rose for 3 years.
Yeah, it's awesome. I love it.
Kissed by a rose on the game.
It's one of the funniest. It's one of the funnest hangs. Like I just spend like 2 hours laughing.
Most fun.
That's it. Happy New Year, right, to the fans? Happy
New
Year.
Wait, hold on. This isn't the New Year show, though. No.
But it's live right now. I've never watched it.
It's live right
Happy
now.
Happy New Year, guys.
You know, your breaks are going to cost you $200, but, you know, I don't know if I can do anything for the pads. I think your main line's out.
It's
know.
Always something extra, too. You got to add something extra.
Not for nothing. You look at it, you got to get new wipers.
Yeah, fluid. The fluid's not good enough.
Your alternator is shot.
Your main line,
you know.
Lines problem.
But thanks for coming out to Midas Flushing.
I'm service agent, Chris.
Feel free to go to Midas.com. Give us a rating. What you thought of our service.
You know, we loved it if you became a local business.
Go Mets.
I love the Mets.
All right, guys, thanks so much for listening to YKWD.
You know what?
I've been your host, Dan Soder.
We've all done
My
it
name
together.
Is Giannis Christos Papuska Briska Barasta.
Tzatziki sauce.
They're lamb twice, that's bomb. God damn it.
Well, you know, whoever holds the wig last.
Doesn't hold it! I put it on my legs. I love you, Sam Morril.
Yeah, thanks for listening, everybody. Sam Morril.
I love
Joe
you, Joe List.
Dan Soder. Louis Gomez.
Whoa.
Louis J. Barnaby. Louis the Animal Steel. Scopo. That's it, right?
Yannis Pepe.
Yannis Fredikos Christos Papa.
Yannis Pepe.
Guys, tune in to Wepa in the Morning whenever you get a chance.
I'm Yannis from Wepa. Morning, Miami. We got
you
a little bit
of a win guest.
Anchorage, Alaska, or Miami, you can get this show.
Fucking hey, Giannis's next rose for next year will be a weatherman in Jacksonville. He's gonna slowly work his way back up to New York. Fucking weekend weatherman. All right. Been a fun show.
All right, good night,
bye, everybody.
Fun hang.
Two scores left. Don't get in my way. It's Robert Kelly.
Today's You Know What Do podcast on riotcast.com.
Fucking hell.
No, that's really sweet of you guys. Sorry. I just bought it. That's really nice of you to all say that. I bought it at Bloomingdale's, and that's amazing that you said all those nice things for 26 days.
Lou just spit on me during the intro.
Why?
He needed attention in some way.
Well, you might start off.
She looked like she was sweating, so I spit water at her.
She always looks like she's sweating.
I am sweating. That's what it is.
all right, let's go through the first of all. All right, this is going to be a weird show. I can already tell. Just the energy's off. Joe's off.
No, Joe's on already.
I'm on. I'm bringing the heat. I got the best shirt you've ever seen on.
That shirt is ridiculous.
He's killer.
Scobo, let's introduce the room from here down.
Oh, we
Bobby doesn't know his left to right.
Deepu. The man behind the computer.
First.
Because you know what? It's proper.
That's like if it was a TV show and they're like, yeah, first key group is Joe fucking Dickface.
I'm introducing Deepu. Deepu, moment of time.
Thanks for introducing me. How you doing?
No problem.
Good on you, Chris.
You just lost 10% of your viewers because they're like, all right, this is taking too long.
He's good.
If you would shut up, I would go to Sean next. But you fucking, whoa.
Dude, you fucking jibba jabbing, dude.
You introduced somebody less famous than Deepu. Great.
Lewis does have a point. Yes. You should have started with our guests. We always start with our guests, and we do the crew at the end.
Also, none of us are on the fame spectrum. 0%.
That's not true.
Oh, boy. What are you talking about? That's different.
Then we have Joe List. Can you get Sean? Did you say Sean?
I said Sean, yes.
You said Sean. Sean,
did you plug the website?
Oh, thanks, Robert.
Welcome to the show.
I did not plug the Comics Comic.
Yes, that's the
From the Comics Comic.
Yes. .com, yeah.
And the podcast.
And he has a podcast.
Yeah,
yes.
Comic presents Last Thing First.
No, very original. No.
You just did it.
I know I did. I was forced to. Listen.
Here comes a replicator.
Welcome to the show. You were on the show before.
Yeah, I've seen it in a couple different furnishings.
No, you saw it at the beginning when we first got up here. And then you saw it when we made it kind of a studio. And now
it's legit.
Though. It's legit. It actually is. It's no more smoke and mirrors. We used to hang blankets up everywhere and frame in every shot. It'd be like a book of some weird fucking gnome computer flipping out.
Yeah. No more smoke and mirrors. It looks like there's no mirrors anywhere in the world.
Oh! Next up, we have a Joe List, a.k.a. apparently he's fucking perfectly fine.
Shirt.
Yeah, we got this shirt.
He wore that shirt for the Comic Central roast battle.
I'm still in roast mode. Look out, everybody. Hey, you're gay. I'm all roasted up, baby.
That shirt is just awful.
Yeah, that's a important.
Look at something Josie and the Pussycat.
I saved your own chasing for you.
That's because fucking Lewis was somewhere on another planet. Pay attention.
I'm paying attention. It was not funny.
We got Lewis. We got Lewis Gomez, a.k.a.
Really? Gomez.
Lewis.
Gomez.
Yes, really, dude.
I'm it's right in your fucking glasses.
It's always funny. It's funny when we don't say the J, because you still get mad. It still makes me laugh.
You know what I say? I say Lewis Gay Gomez. Really stick it to him. Roast mode.
Now he's going to have a fucking heart attack. You hear that laugh just there?
Oh my God, she's just cancer laughs. Smoking Australian cigarettes.
I miss Joe.
Louis J. Gomez, a.k.a. the fucking Puerto Rican rattlesnake, the Joan Jett of comedy, the Black Knight.
He's a giant yellow knight, I would say.
Jaundice.
Yeah, you do look like you have. I, you guys, of course, you got fucking tackle smell.
Tango.
Roast.
Oh, boy.
Kelly Festuca's back.
Hi, mate.
To
thank
her
stomach. You.
She's back.
Baby.
I missed you guys.
You are the Apex champion.
Sean, you're so lucky.
Oh, God.
Kelly's
so lucky.
She just got stomach from Australia.
I didn't know what that means.
We really yes-ended. Back is a body part.
I got
Jesus.
And then he made a.
I got fucking Deepu the fucking magician on the video. I got Scopo, the booker of the show, the producer. I got the gorgeous Lauren.
And single, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, her mic's not on.
What
the fuck? Bobby hates women. Bobby hates women. And are you single and also looking to mingle or just single?
Single.
Why is her mic not working?
Oh, no. Oh.
It might have just shut down from never being necessary.
Talk.
This mic is not on.
Do, do, do.
Do, 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 do.
Okay,
here.
Hey.
Hey.
Now you better say something really profound.
Bobby, snap.
It was me.
I'm mingling.
I did not check her mic, no.
Fucking Chris. Literally.
Everyone else.
We had a fucking.
Kelly's single and looking for Pringles.
Can I explain something? me and Chris had a blowout 2 weeks ago. Fucking, it's
you didn't
crazy.
Invite me?
Crazy about everything. And all right. My therapist.
We're over.
3, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3.
Hey, Bob.
Yeah, what?
I love your glasses. They look so good on you.
Thank you.
You
why are yours
handsome.
Fogged up?
I know.
You really do.
Really
what are you,
I just
what are you playing
them.
Football on the snow?
Well, I don't know, man. Well, you look good.
Oh, wow, shit. I'm sorry. You look good, too?
No, I don't want it back. It's fine.
We got, of course, Lauren. And how you doing,
hey,
sweetie?
Bob. Doing good.
You still single?
Still single.
Are you looking to mingle?
Always.
All right. Well, you guys are both orange.
I want this to happen, Lewis and Lauren.
I want it to happen, too.
Yeah,
I
don't. Lewis will take her.
Of course
nice
you do.
Date.
You want Lauren gone.
Knocked up.
She's not Kelly. Come
she's
on.
Get her pregnant and she yeah. can't come in anymore.
I was thinking Hep C or AIDS, but go ahead. Whatever
I
you.
I can think of a good guy for you. Wait, how old are you? Can I ask?
29.
29, that's young.
Mm. I was going to say
I'm
too old.
I was thinking December.
I was thinking Griffin.
Who? Fucking.
Nick Griffin.
Yeah, that's good.
Yeah. He's a single guy. He's sweet. He's hilarious. He's very handsome.
Nick Griffin.
One of the best comedians of all time.
It's like fucking
50. I don't like that this guy's taking notes. Why is he taking notes? Oh, sorry.
Oh. That's how boring the show is. He's like, I don't want to doodle right now.
What about, I can think of some other people.
Introduce our guest, my friend.
Here we go. We got.
They're already introduced.
Christoph.
Why is your not?
Oh, hey, Christoph. I know Christoph.
Christoph, how you doing, buddy? You've been on before.
No, I haven't.
You met him.
No, you're thinking of me.
Shows we did
you're
thinking
of oh, the shows.
You're
okay,
thinking
yeah.
of the ice truck killer.
Well, you did walk in, and you really didn't seem happy.
I'm just a little shy.
Are you shy?
Yeah, I am.
So aren't killers. are you an artist?
Yeah, I work at a film studio as a sculptor.
Oh, cool.
During the day.
Didn't we talk to him
before?
Yeah, like, we talked to you before.
We talked at the one in Connecticut.
Yeah, you're a comic from out of town, and you just got here, and you actually have this crazy story, right?
That was like a year ago.
Oh, did it all fall apart?
No.
Oh, okay.
It's actually gone pretty well.
Oh, good, man. Yeah.
Your stand-up comedy career?
Yeah.
No.
Well, it's gotten better.
Get out of here.
I mean, he followed me at McLaughlin's last week, so.
Yeah, it's pretty good.
So you're still opening?
Yeah.
You're opening for an unknown comic?
Not the unknown comic.
It's very mean in here tonight. I don't know, I just
it's a mean atmosphere.
What do you mean, homo?
Sorry.
All right. Anyways, it's a fucking we're back. I did. I want to bring up.
Was that a commercial break? What happened?
I want to bring up something that was really fucking, I think, epic this weekend.
Orlando
game
was last weekend.
Seven of the. Okay.
No. Lewis. The fucking Game of Thrones was so good. I mean, it was the best one they've had.
It really was. Well, episode two, when Jon Snow came back.
That was great, but this week with the fucking giant.
Did you watch the anatomy of the scene? They have it on HBO. They like break down how they shot it.
Really?
Fucking awesome.
What? And I actually almost had to turn it off because I have claustrophobia. And there's one scene in, I'm not going to spoil it, but there's one scene. Well, me and my wife has it bad, and we were both like, we were almost shutting it off, because it's a fucking, they kept going and going.
You
and
just say it.
No,
I don't want to do it. You can.
That's not a spoiler if it's 3 days after the fact.
Yeah.
No.
It had to come out a week after.
Wait.
I mean, it's kind of
It's not a spoiler fucking 5 years ago before, you know, when people were dealing with TiVo. I mean, everybody has a DVR. There's
a battle and the fucking Jon Snow gets buried under a bunch of people.
I didn't say it. Lewis
said it. That's not a fucking spoiler. Oh, that's not even a crazy thing.
Yeah. Well, the battle is. You told him there was a battle.
It's called the Battle of the Bastards, you fucking fucktard.
Yeah.
He's just aggressively mean.
The name of the episode is called the Battle of the Bastards.
Give me something to throw
it. Yeah, throw it.
Oh, we bought some for you.
I hope
for
you throw out your shoulder.
Well, Lauren bought something, and I'm going to take credit.
Thanks.
Borrow one of Kelly's water balloons.
That's her tit.
Oh, shit. Why is it
leaking? No, seriously.
Kelly brought a sack of potatoes that she's hiding in her shirt.
There you go. Fucking panicked on sack of potatoes, you fucking mumbling cunt.
I don't know about that bandana. She's dying laughing. Hey, I chuckled.
She's dying laughing at me. He said, he stumbled on sack of potatoes.
There's an asterisk on that bandana.
No, I'm laughing because he got the bandana. That makes me happy.
What are they doing over there?
Don't What's worry happening? About them. They're part of the crew. You worry about who's next to you, left and right.
Joe, not shit.
Luis J. Gomez, Sean L. McCurry.